everyone. Happy Halloween. Welcome to Intense Wrestling. This is a crossover special. We've got Mountaintop, we've got Genesis, and we've got Virtual Shock all together for a Halloween special. Let's get right into the action. And to start us off, we've got the Chosen One taking on the undefeated Brutus Armstrong. Now, the spookier gimmicks aren't going to be in costume for obvious reasons. Yeah, they're already kind of spooky as it is. But we have plenty of people like Brutus Armstrong and many others who are in costume tonight to celebrate the holiday. Anyway, here comes the Chosen One, the current hardcore champion. This is gonna get interesting. Here he comes. There he is. The Chosen One. The hardcore champion. And he's ready to square off against the undefeated Brutus Armstrong. Now, when it comes to the Chosen One, he has had a fair share of accolades in his time. A former Intercontinental Champion and the current Hardcore Champion, the Chosen One has proven his capabilities in the ring by being able to win some big prizes. But he might be up against one of his, if not his, toughest opponent to date. Now, this is a non-title match. The Hardcore Championship is not on the line tonight. This is mainly a little bit of a for fun night before we head into the World League event, which if you haven't seen the last few episodes of Mountaintop, I highly recommend you do so, as we've been setting up qualifiers for World League. Definitely tune in to Mountaintop. You know, check back on those episodes after you're done watching this, of course. But yes, anyway, the Chosen One up against the undefeated Brutus Armstrong, and this is going to be very difficult for the Chosen One. Well, here he comes. Here comes Brutus Armstrong in costume. It's Rubius Hagrid. He's here. Oh my god. He's here. Oh, this is going to be fun. Now, obviously, if you're not already familiar with how things usually work in Intense Wrestling, normally we have an episode of Mountaintop, we have an episode of Genesis we have Mountaintop usually on Mondays when we can, Genesis on Wednesdays, and Virtual Shock on Fridays. Obviously, those days change if we're a little bit behind. But this week, we're doing it all wrapped into one, which is why this video is going to be longer than usual, wrapping around at about 2.5 hours, which is actually shorter than if they were 3 separate shows this week. But we decided to do this because we wanted to do a nice little thing to celebrate Halloween. If you like holiday specials like this from Intense Wrestling, please let us know by leaving a like and commenting down below. It lets us know that we should do more like this. Maybe Christmas time we'll do another one like this. Anyway, oh, here we go. This match is gonna get good. I'm almost certain of this. Because despite the costume, Brutus Armstrong is someone who I find very entertaining. Undefeated for a reason, Brutus Armstrong is one of the biggest, meanest men you'll ever come across. Ooh! And the Chosen One, becoming familiar with that. Got outside of the ring, but Brutus is hot on the trail here. And the Chosen One striking. What a beautiful, powerful slam from the Chosen One. Oh, misses with a knee, but Chosen One sending Brutus into the LED board. Oh ho ho, Brutus though, not fazed in the slightest. Oh, my goodness. Oh, taking the chosen one down. Now, they've got to be careful. The referee is counting. They do not want to be counted out just yet. And now they're going back into the ring here. The chosen one trying to go after Brutus, but Brutus picks up the chosen one. Now, I should point out, the chosen one is a lot larger than you think. It's just that he's up against an equally large opponent in Brutus Armstrong. So it is not easy to pick up the chosen one that easily. Now wrenching on the head here, trying to wear the chosen one out, but the chosen one, boom! Nice work right there. Great way of escaping the offense, and now chosen one. Oh, tried to go for some strikes, but now a clothesline from Brutus Armstrong. But the chosen one immediately back up to his feet. You can now, as the hardcore champion, you have to assume that chosen one is very much capable of taking some nasty shots. Now going for a submission hold. The chosen one is great at exacting pain onto his opponents, but he's up against Brutus Armstrong, who is nearly unstoppable. We've yet to see a single person ever beat Brutus Armstrong in the ring. Oh my goodness. Chosen one doing quite well though, I must admit. Oh, did you hear the smack on that one? Chosen one Irish whip into the corner, going over. Oh, nice work there. And going in for a spear. And still not enough to take down Brutus Armstrong, who goes in and drives the elbow across the chest. And this is getting to be quite nasty. A fireman's carry from the chosen one. And now the chosen one. Ooh, chosen one's got something planned here. Oh, I think his plans were cut short because Brutus was immediately getting up. Oh my goodness, a beel toss from Brutus Armstrong. The supreme strength of Rubius Hagrid here. My oh my. Oh, look at this. Gonna go for a nice splash to incapacitate the chosen one. And now bringing Chosen One up to his feet. But Chosen One with a back toss here. But look at that. Brutus catching the leg. Good leg screw right there. Nice snap. And going to take the Chosen One. Oh, he's taking him to the corner. Oh, this is going to get nasty. Look at that. Boom, 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 boom. And that is going to leave you with a very sore head in the morning. Brutus Armstrong picks up the chosen one and he goes for the snake eyes. Now bringing the chosen one back up. Oh, going for another headlock here. I think Brutus is going to have to hit with a much bigger move than this if he wants to put the chosen one away. He's starting to get the upper hand, but he's giving the chosen one opportunities to come back like this. Ooh. But the chosen one, oh my goodness, not able to capitalize. Going for the pinfall now. One, two, and a kick out at two. Like I said, Brutus is going to have to hit with some truly big maneuvers if he wants to put this one away. Oh, Brutus now. Big arm across the back there. And, oh, going for the arm. But the chosen one makes an escape. Oh, but Brutus not fazed by an elbow to the head. And now brings the chosen one back up to his feet. Oh, the bicycle kick, and that is gonna do it. Here we go, the pinfall. I don't know, the bicycle kick, two, three. Brutus Armstrong's undefeated streak continues. Oh my goodness. Now that was certainly something right there. Good Lord. Oh, that was certainly something else. Great job from Brutus Armstrong. Another win. The bicycle kick, not even his finisher, but has put away a number of opponents at this point. A number of high-level opponents. That goes to show you how powerful that bicycle kick really is. But Brutus Armstrong, successful, and my, oh my. Is anyone going to stop that undefeated streak? Well, now we move on to Intense Wrestling Genesis. It's Kamal versus GHK's Caligar. So obviously GHK still on hiatus at the moment, but we thought it'd be nice to bring over some GHK talents for some of this special crossover action. And here comes Kamal, dressed up as the Shockmaster. Oh, this is gonna be interesting. This is... Oh my god. The weirdest part is he does oddly look like the Shockmaster. That's... That is terrifying. Oh my goodness. So if you're not already aware, I should point out that a costume doesn't mean it's an endorsement of any like intellectual property or creator behind intellectual property. This is purely just for shits and giggles. But I'd say, given what the person who made Hagrid's been saying lately, we don't endorse that. Oh, man. Well, it there. Oh, my goodness. Now, Kamal has been doing incredibly well lately in Intense Wrestling. In the Limitless Championship hunt, Kamal won his triple threat match. Oh my goodness, here comes Caligar! But yeah, Kamal been doing very well for himself. I think he's got this against Caligar. Like, Caligar alike, but Kamal has been just on a tear as of late. Oh lordy. We're gonna get this, aren't we? Oh no! For fuck's sake! If you're not aware, Caligar is weirdly in sync with his music, and that is not intentional. Oh, you're fucking joking! Oh no, is this how it's gonna be? Please tell me this isn't how it's gonna be. Oh, Kamal! The belly to belly. Now, Caligar is a strange, disturbed creature. Is Caligar. Caligar is a strange, disturbed creature. And just weird even by GHK standards. Oh, and there we go. Now, Kamal was going off well at the start here. Oh, he's coming back. Look at Kamal, though. So dominant. Jesus Christ. Oh, Caligar with an uppercut. Oh, he only staggers Kamal. Can't take Kamal off of his feet. Irish whip. Oh, ducks under. And a big boot finally takes Kamal off of his feet. Caligar is very strange. Oh, roll, small package. Two, oh, kick out by Kamal. Very nearly Caligar stole the match there. But Kamal, back in control. Now, the thing with Kamal is, he is already quite large, but he wrestles like he is twice his size. He's very good at using his weight to its absolute, to the best of his advantage. He is possibly, like, his size is never a disadvantage for him. He always knows how to use it to the best of his ability, and it makes him so hard for a lot of people to deal with, Kamal. Because he can just overpower them so easily. Even someone like Caligar, who is usually quite a dangerous opponent. Wow, oh wow. And now Kamal bringing Caligar up. Oh, good lord. Kamal, though, getting back in now after that. But Caligar... Oh, he's taking Kamal down! Oh, no! Oh! Nice work there from Kalagar. Oh my word. And now Irish Whip sends Kamau tumbling to the outside, and Kalagar. His bizarre behaviour at times really throws me off. Oh, good lord, Kamau with a power slam right onto the outside. Now, if Kalagar wasn't a GHK talent, I would have said that would put him out. But obviously, Kalagar's from GHK, so not only is he strange, not only is he bizarre, but he's very resilient. Oh, here we go now. Kamau taking Kalagar over to the steel steps, but Kalagar's not going to let that happen. Oh, they've got to be careful. I've just roused the referee. I couldn't even hear the ref over the music. He was at a count of seven there. Wow, they have got to be careful. Oh, Russian leg sweep from Kalagar. And he is very happy right now. But Kamau's already back up. Oh, good lord. I was just saying, Kamau's back up to his feet. He keeps getting back up, but Kalagar keeps taking him back down and right into the corner. Oh, but out of the way. Oh, Kamau, gotta look for something big here. Oh, watch this, face first into the turnbuckle. But Kalagar, oh my goodness, clothesline from hell. Two, oh, the kick out at two. It's not over yet. Oh, here we go. Kalagar looking to put this one away. And I think Kamau is down. I think he's done. This is it. Here we go. Ref, count it. One, two. No, Kamau kicks out at two. Now, I've got to say, the referee should have been a bit more quicker on the ball and might have given Kalagar the victory, but obviously a referee's not always, can't always be 100% on the ball all the time. There is always the chance of human error. Kamau, though, breaking out of the camel clutch now. And Kalagar has to keep on working if he wants to put Kamau away. Oh, here we go. Look at this. Oh, good lord, Kalagar! Taken down with a flatliner. From the top rope as well. That is going to hurt. But go! Kalagar tried to fight back, but Kamau is relentless. And now Kamau chasing after Kalagar. The Shockmaster is going to shock the world when he beats Kalagar. My goodness. That is nasty. That is very, very nasty right there. Oh my goodness. Now they got to be careful of the referee. This isn't GHK. There are countouts. Kalagar's got to keep being mindful of that. Oh! Doesn't look like he cares. Sending Kamau into the steel steps. He just wants to cause Kamau untold amounts of pain. And they're at an 8 count now. They need to get back in the ring right the hell now. Count of 9. Kalagar, you got to get your ass in there. And he's in. Oh. But Kamau looking to put this one away. Kalagar rolling out of the ring again. And Kamau looks to be closing in. The Shockmaster could get himself a victory here. Oh, but a Russian leg sweep on the outside. Kalagar still going to keep on giving it what he can against Kamau. But Kamau just seems unstoppable. Oh. Ooh, oh my goodness. What? Oh, pinfall. One, two. Oh my goodness, I was saying Kamau seems unstoppable, but Kalagar doesn't work on normal human logic. After all that abuse, he's still going like nothing's even wrong. Kamau getting to his feet, takes, oh no! He tried to go for a spear, but it was reversed into a DDT. How is Kalagar doing this? Oh god, Kalagar on the top rope. No! Oh! Clothesline from the top. And Kamau, I think he is out of it. Look at it, stiff kicks to the gut. Oh, Kamau trying to fight back now. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Kamau with the torture rack and it's over. This, it's over. Kalagar, he's going to either tap out or pass out. No, wait a minute. Kalagar's escaped.
Do we call that the Judas effect?
Oh my goodness. No way. One, two, three. Kalagar's won. Kalagar with the shock victory. I would not have expected that given how much Kamau has been doing lately. But Kalagar proving why he's such a big deal in GHK. Oh my goodness. Kalagar is such an unpredictable entity. And it looks like Kalagar has the ability to beat top level talents, or at least rising talents like Kamau. What's that gonna mean for Kalagar in GHK in 2K19. Oh! And Kalagar is victorious tonight on Halloween. Oh my goodness. I cannot wait to see what Kalagar does when GHK returns. Well, now we're moving on to Intense Wrestling's Virtual Shock. It's Plague Princess taking on Untouchable. So we're starting you off with Virtual Shock with a doozy here. Two big powerhouses in Virtual Shock. Plague Princess, who is not the largest athlete by any means on Virtual Shock, but has proven to be almost the kryptonite for powerhouses when she took on the Forsaken. Now in doing that, she managed to take out the Forsaken in a surprise victory in the Global Championship Tournament. Let me just get my notes out. I'm recording so much Intense Wrestling at this point that I have to have notes. Where? See, but here comes Plague Princess. There she is. She is quite dominant when she can be, which I did not expect, but she has proven her capability. Now, she lost in the last episode of Intense Wrestling's Virtual Shock to Willow, so she will not be the global champion, but Untouchable is still in the running. However, Plague Princess has never faced Untouchable, so Plague Princess could still show what she's capable of by taking on and defeating another huge powerhouse in the women's division. Plague Princess is definitely an odd, mysterious entity in the roster. Reminds me of the like of other similar unknowing creatures like Black Death, Kalagar, and the like. Just, you don't know what's going on behind that mask. But I do know what's going on behind that Kane mask. It's Untouchable. Now, Untouchable, the largest woman on the roster, possibly, in my opinion, the most powerful woman on the roster. Untouchable is, in my opinion, going to become the global champion. She has to beat Willow in the final in order to do that. But as good as Willow is, Untouchable is terrifying. Now, Untouchable this year for Halloween is dressed as Kane. Even got her hair shaved for this one. Look at this. My oh my. So obviously Untouchable doesn't normally look like this, obviously in costume, but She, Untouchable is a devastating person in that ring. Like,
I believe, like, if you check, let me see,
just double checking my notes. Last week, or, you know, she faced Hope Halliwell, and Hope Halliwell had a minor injury. Now, Hope is cleared to compete, which will be later tonight. But Hope Halliwell took too much abuse at the hands of Untouchable in their match together, and Untouchable had to call the match a little earlier than she normally would have. And that's why I think Untouchable is a shoo-in for the Global Championship, because as good as the likes of Willow and Plague Princess are, Untouchable is just terrifying. Oh, but Plague Princess there, nice shoulder back toss right there. And it looks like this, it looks like we're seeing a bit of a dead even start at the moment, as Untouchable starting to try and work on the arm of Plague Princess here. And Plague Princess can't seem to out-muscle. Oh, there we go. Now, we're getting to see what I was saying about Plague Princess being able to take on powerhouses. Noticeably smaller than Untouchable, but Plague Princess doing a good job of fighting Untouchable off. But Untouchable, picks her up and a rake to the eyes. This is what I was saying. Plague Princess seems to be the kryptonite to powerhouses, which is not what I expected. But it seems to be paying her very well here as she picks up Untouchable and slams her down, throwing her towards the corner. Now wrenching on the head here, trying to wear Untouchable down. And this is a good sign for Plague Princess here. Bringing up Untouchable, wrenching on the head some more here. Now Plague Princess is doing very well at the moment. Normally when we see Untouchable in the ring, she's normally extremely dominant, but Plague Princess is doing very well for herself, going for an early pinfall here, but I think it's too early. Yes, not even a one count. And, Plague Princess gets right back onto the offense, but Untouchable takes Plague Princess to the ground. But Plague Princess still comes out swinging. All right, into the corner and takes Untouchable to the ground. Oh, look at this now, wrenching on the head once again. But Untouchable cuts it short. Tries to go for a big boot, but misses. And now Plague Princess takes Untouchable up and down. Driving the, doing damage to the knee there, and an elbow drop from Plague Princess. Untouchable being dragged over to the center of the ring. Plague Princess going to go again for another pinfall here. Only a one count. And that shows that Plague Princess is nowhere near done with Untouchable here. If she wants to get Untouchable's shoulders down for that free count, she is going to have to work a lot harder. Untouchable is a very difficult opponent to defeat. Plague Princess doing quite well, though, it must be said. There are a few rest holds, but she's just been maintaining control. Now Untouchable looking to try and make a comeback here. Oh my god, what a forceful punch to take Plague Princess off of her feet. And now a beel toss right there. And look at this, just getting right... Just dishing out some major blows to Plague Princess now. And this is the thing, you want to remain in control in a match against Untouchable, because if Untouchable takes over, it is going to be so hard to claw the match back. Oh, look at the strength of Untouchable with the Gorilla Press Slam. Oh, look at this. And a big chop to the head. And Plague Princess has to roll out the ring to get a chance to recover. And now Plague Princess is going to try and get the match back in her favor. Nice back toss right there from Plague Princess. Now, Plague Princess, like I said, has been a bit of a mystery, a bit of a wild card in the Virtual Shock roster. Obviously, you can tell she's quite a mysterious person by looking at her, but she's also proven to be a lot more devastating than I would have given her credit for. The fact that she was able to... Only a one count. The fact that she's able to put up this much of a fight against Untouchable, who I would consider one of the top-tier women's wrestlers, it kind of goes to show what Plague Princess is capable of and the surprising amount of strength she has. Now, on the other hand, we have Untouchable here, the largest woman, and in my opinion, the most powerful. We have a fair few very strong, very large competitors in the women's roster right now in Virtual Shop. But I'd say if we were ranking them by strength and size, Untouchable would be the biggest. But Plague Princess, like I mentioned before, seems to be like the kryptonite for that style of wrestling. Oh, but call for big boot there. And that's, I'm surprised the beak wasn't bent from that. Oh, Untouchable is getting right to work here. Going for the pinfall. Only a one count, though. Plague Princess still got a lot to give, and Untouchable has got to hit a lot harder if she wants to put Plague Princess away. Oh, look at this. Big side slam. And this is usually the beginning of the end. Two count. No. This is usually the beginning of the end, and I think it's very quickly looking to be. Now Untouchable going for the legs. Oh, but Plague Princess right back up again. No way. Plague Princess is looking to put this one away. Oh, the double-headed choke slam. One, two, no, and a kick out at two. But my goodness, that was a sluggish kick out from Untouchable. I think Plague Princess is bringing Untouchable to her limits here. And the fans are certainly enjoying this one. My, oh my, but Untouchable, oh, she's back up. And now Irish Whip sending Plague Princess to the outside. Oh, this is going to get messy if they're going to brawl on the outside like this. Ooh, Plague Princess there gets Untouchable. Oh, a back and forth at the moment between Plague Princess and Untouchable as they brawl on the outside. But Untouchable gets back into the ring. Doesn't want to get counted out. Oh, belly to belly. And now bringing Plague Princess back up. But Plague Princess, boom, shoulder first into Untouchable. Untouchable rolls back out to try and recover. Untouchable, I don't think she expected quite this big a fight from Plague Princess. I think this might be Untouchable's hardest fight yet. Oh, nice series of blows there, and Plague Princess has been down. And now going for the legs. Ooh, Untouchable just working Plague Princess over now. I think we're looking at the beginning of the end for Plague Princess. Plague Princess hit a finish and it wasn't enough to put Untouchable away. Okay, going for a pinfall here. Two, only a two count. I think Untouchable was seeing about giving Plague Princess an out. Trying to not do damage to Plague Princess like she did to Hope Halliwell. Untouchable may be a beast, but she's not a monster. I think she wants to avoid potentially injuring an opponent like what happened with Hope Halliwell. Though, to be fair, Hope Halliwell was a lot smaller and likely a lot less capable of taking bumps like Plague Princess. Oh, here we go though. Plague Princess with a big clothesline taking Untouchable to the ground. Plague Princess showing that she still has a lot to give here. Oh, grabbing Untouchable and bringing her down. Good work there from Plague Princess. And now grabbing Untouchable here. Got something big planned. But oh, reverses it. DDT. DDT from Untouchable. Bringing Plague Princess, not wasting any time. Going for another big power slam. One, two, three. We're seeing a surprising lack of finishes in some of these matches, I'm finding. Because Untouchable's finish isn't that side slam, but you can see how much damage it does by the fact that she managed to get a pinfall victory from Plague Princess there. Now, I feel like at one point, Untouchable, like I said, wanted to try and be careful, doesn't want to go too far. But Plague Princess showed she was more than ready to keep on going. So Untouchable, she fired the killing bullet to put Plague Princess down. We saw it happen about here. Boom with the DDT. And then it was just the power, it was just the side slam, and that was it. Untouchable with another emphatic victory. untouchable, proving why she is one to watch. Now, the Global Championship isn't the World Championship. It's the Global Championship, for those who aren't aware, is the equivalent to the Intercontinental title for the women's division. But unless Willow pulls a major upset, I've got to say, I still think that Untouchable has this one. If you want to find out for yourself, though, stay tuned to Intense Wrestling Virtual Shop next week. Well, now we're going back to Intense Wrestling's Mountaintop. We've got a triple threat match. It's Thomas Swole, Black Death, and Herman. Now, Black Death, So far, I think in terms of people who haven't been in costume, we've had The Chosen One, we've had Caligar, Plague Princess, and Black Death. Yeah, Chosen One, Caligar, Plague Princess, and Black Death. Yeah, so those are the people who aren't in costume because they're already scary enough as is. Now, if you're not familiar with Black Death lately has been trying to help the Reaper. Him and Scarecrow have been aligned with the Reaper, the biggest guy, or the biggest scary act in Intense Wrestling at the moment, former Reaper, a former world champion. Black Death, a former Intercontinental champion, and the longest reigning Intercontinental champion. Now, when it comes to Black Death, he has proven time and time again that he is not one to be messed with. Now, Black Death trying to join forces with the Reaper to fight against the Storm System. Now, despite that, Thomas Swole managed to get the Reaper on his own, and he destroyed the Intense Wrestling Mountaintop ring. Now, thankfully, it turns out that the damage to the ring wasn't as severe as we thought, so we were able to fix the ring. But my God, he got us worried. Speaking of Thomas Swole, here he comes, is as the Incredible Hulk. Now, Thomas Swole, the newest member of the Storm System, at least in the men's division, and he has been on a tear lately. Thomas Swole qualified for the World League tournament, which you'll be seeing, World League event, in a few days' time. And he destroyed the ring, beating up the Reaper. This is a man whose strength is apparently not just too much for the competitors at Mountaintop, not just too much for one of the biggest members of the roster in the Reaper, but too much for the Intense Wrestling ring. Now that's insanity, but that shows how devastating Thomas Swole truly is. Now, here comes one of my favorite competitors. I love Black Death, don't get me wrong, I love Black Death, but I love Herman, who is dressed as, let me get the notes again. Herman is dressed as the ghost of Captain Cutler from Scooby-Doo. Oh my Lord. There he is, Herman, the largest man on Intense Wrestling, standing at an impressive 7'4". The largest athlete in Intense Wrestling, the tallest, weighs the most. It's just a massive combination. He's also one of the older competitors on the roster. Now, Herman also qualified for the World League tournament. And I know that he is definitely... It's very weird talking about these competitors seriously when they look like this. It's a very good costume, I must say. But if you've seen The Ghost of Captain Cutler, I mean, that's not bad. That's pretty good. That must have cost a lot of money, Herman. Oh, my word. He always puts in an extra bit of effort on the holidays. But yeah, Herman qualifying, he's made it clear that he knows that he's in his twilight years, but he wants to get at least one more run with the world title before he retires. And he's still very capable in the ring despite his age, so it's very possible. Oh, Black Death trying to deal with Herman here. Oh, Herman takes Black Death to the ground. We have some mighty opponents in this match. We have the longest reigning Intercontinental Champion in Black Death. We have Thomas Swole, who has been tearing things up. And we have the largest athlete in Intense Wrestling in Herman. Oh, look at this, a nice back and forth. And Herman comes out on top on the back and forth there between him and Black Death. But Black Death not fazed, not moved by Herman. Now Thomas Swole with a suplex. Now it's between Thomas Swole and Herman. And, oh, Herman taken down by Thomas Swole. Oh, Thomas Swole and Herman back and forth for the moment. Oh, oh my goodness. Thank God he went for a strike to the head. I was a little worried. We do not want another superplex. We have a whole night of action. We do not need the Intense Wrestling mountaintop ring being broken here. Good Lord. Now look at this. Black Death trying to deal with two men at once. He's dealt with Thomas Swole and now trying to deal with Herman. Now going for a pinfall here. Now Black Death, while I think he is entitled to an Intercontinental Championship rematch, he isn't going to be going for it in Mountains in the World League pay-per-view. That championship match is going to go between Wholesome Shaw and the current champion, the War Beast Mammoth. Thomas Swole taken out just as soon as he got back in. Yeah, I think Black Death is still entitled to a rematch, but it's not going to be at the World League pay-per-view. Right now, he's focusing on helping the Reaper deal with the Storm System, likely why he went straight for Thomas Swole, who is a member of the Storm System. If you're not familiar with Storm System Worldwide, then they are a group of people who believe that they are better than everyone else. And they sell their workout regimens and supplements to the unknowing public, saying that they too can look like them. But obviously, if you look at people like Thomas Swole and the leader of the Storm System, Aaron Storm, you begin to see that it's quite suspect how they would get bodies like that. Oh my goodness. And so a lot of people have pointed out that it's really just a big scam by Aaron Storm and company. Oh, now Herman in control here against Thomas Swole. And good work right now by Herman. Now Herman is nicknamed backstage the Big Friendly Giant, and that's because he is extremely amicable towards a lot of people backstage. He's been in the business for a long time and he's built himself a lot of good relations over time. Just proven himself to be very, just very well liked. Now Black Death going for the pin here. One, two, and a kick out at two. But yeah, Herman very well liked backstage. And I imagine he's getting a lot of support as he gets himself ready for the World League tournament. Now, he's been having some trouble with his best friend, Greg, who a lot of people do not like, but Herman is trying to give Greg another chance. And then we have Black Death, who, like I've said before, longest reigning Intercontinental Champion, and he is proving why that is here. He is dominating this matchup. Two, oh, only a two count. Herman kicks out there. Black Death, this, you look at him and you look at the opponents and you'd think it's obvious who would be on top. You've got a giant and you've got an extremely over-muscular man there. You think Black Death would be in huge trouble, but he is very capable of taking on all opponents. Taken out there by Thomas Swole, who goes for the pin on Herman, but a kick out there. Herman had a chance to recover. But Black Death has proven time and time again that he's very capable of taking on a wide variety of opponents. That's why his championship reign lasted for so long. And now Thomas Swole going for the pinfall here. One, two, and a kick out at two. Black Death getting ready here. Oh, but Thomas Swole not wasting any time. Black Death was calling to the dark spirits, but it's not going to matter if Thomas Swole cuts the phone wire. Oh, but Black Death takes down Thomas Swole. Now Thomas Swole quickly making his escape. Herman is down and out at the moment. Black Death sees that opportunity, goes for the pinfall. Just a one count though. Herman is still kicking. But I think Herman is starting to reach his limits in this match. And Black Death certainly thinks so, going for the camel clutch here, the referee keeping an eye on things just in case Herman decides to tap out, but Black Death saw Thomas Swole coming, broke up the camel clutch, and now Thomas Swole raking the eyes of Black Death. Oh! Didn't get all of it. And now Thomas Swole stomping away at Black Death and now choking him out, choking the life or the death out of Black Death. Now that is quite nasty from Thomas Swole. Going for the pinfall now. Oh, nearly a two count there. Black Death gets to the outside, trying to make his escape here. And Herman, who has been prone, I think has been out of energy, being targeted by Thomas Swole, who drags Herman over to the center of the ring, goes for a pinfall here. One, just a one count. Herman has been out of it, but clearly still not even close to done. Thomas Swole going to try and put an end to that, though, as he worked over the arm of Herman. Oh, that is nasty. Oh, Black Death is back in this, though. Farman's carry from Black Death. Oh, we've seen this before. Nice work there. Oh, my goodness. Going for the pinfall to Thomas Swole. One, two, three. Black Death wins. If Black Death ever does get that Intercontinental Championship rematch, the War Beast Mammoth better be careful. Because, my God, Black Death just won a triple threat match where he was in the ring with two worldly competitors. Now, Herman was not on his A game in this match, I must say. Normally, we see a lot better from Herman. Thomas Swole was definitely doing very well in that matchup. But Black Death proving why he's one of the elites of professional wrestling. Now that choke from Thomas Swole, who the Storm System are willing to do anything they can in order to win. There was also the eye rake from Thomas Swole to Black Death. It's crazy. The Storm System are very capable of winning matches without cheating. But they'll cheat as long as it gives them more of a chance. A 100% chance of victory is better than a 99% chance, I guess. But in this case, it was a 0% chance because Black Death has won. A huge victory for Black Death. And you've got to think that while the spotlight isn't going to be on him and while Lee, eventually Black Death will make his name known in professional wrestling. Well, now we move back to Intense Wrestling Virtual Shop for tag team action. It's the team of Billy and Christina taking on Pain and Malice. Now we've got tag team action here tonight. Two of the Intense Wrestling Virtual Shop tag teams getting into action here tonight. Now, let me just double check my notes yet once again, because my God, I've been recording like 12 episodes of Intense Wrestling. You can't expect me to keep track of all of this. Billy and Christina were in the tag team tournament, but were already eliminated by the team of Rebecca Storm and one of the other latest members to the Storm System, Sifeng Shang. But Billy and Christina are a very good synchronized tag team. They weren't able to out-muscle their opponents in the tag team title tournament, but Billy and Christina have proven that they are very synchronized as a tag team. I mean, they are sisters and whatnot, so I guess they should know each other very well. The costumes in tonight are ridiculous, I must say. Billy and Christina, obviously not going to be the first United Team Champions, but they have proven their capabilities as a team when you know, in their match together against Sivang and Rebecca, and might prove it some more tonight. And then we focus on Pain and Malice. Now, Pain and Malice, let me see, where's that? They ended up losing to Moxie and Ruby as well. So both of these teams lost in the first round of the tag team tournament. But Pain and Malice have one thing on their side. Both were in the World Championship tournament, and both members managed to move on to the second round, where they then had to face each other. Now, when it comes to that, Pain ended up winning, and Pain is still potentially going to become the next world champion. Pain will be facing Sophia Muller next week. Sophia Muller being the current women's champion, who you'll be seeing later tonight. But yeah, the point is that this is the team who I think has the upper hand in this match, is what I'm trying to say. Because Pain and Malice have proven these past few weeks to be a devastating team, either together or apart. Billy and Christina, the most synchronized team. But Pain and Malice have proven that they're devastating both together and apart. So I don't know who to go for. I think my money's on Pain and Malice. Now, Christina right at the moment, right out the gate, doing quite well here. Oh, nice neck breaker there from Christina. And now Christina grabs a hold of Malice. Malice with the arm drag as she tries to start to make the comeback here. And a boot to Christina here. Going for the leg, driving the foot into the ring mat. And now tagging in Pain. Pain standing over Christina, who gets back to her feet here. Hurricane Rana from Christina. Nice work there. And now Christina gonna go for a big kick to the gut here. Irish whip into the corner. Oh, and Pain gets rear-ended. Good work there once again by Christina, who is doing very well in this one. And now Christina working over the arm of Pain. Currently doing surprisingly well. Normally, Pain and Malice are notoriously difficult to take on. Pain usually, Pain very dominant, and Malice has been seemingly invincible. You know when you've watched like The Fiend at Hell in a Cell, how The Fiend got like several billion like weapon attacks to him from Seth Rollins, and The Fiend just seemed to no-sell all of it? That's what Malice is like. And it seems only Pain is the only person who can bring Malice to her knees. Which, given that Pain is a tag team partner, that goes to show you how terrifying Malice is. And some great teamwork between the sisters here. And now it's Billy's turn. Billy, the younger sister, one of the youngest members of the roster. Oh, don't know what she was going for there. But whatever it was, Billy gonna take Pain into the corner here. Oh, trying to go for a big attack there, but Pain got out of the way. And now Pain with the Lufez press and a series of punches there to daze Billy. Billy being brought back up to her feet here. And now an Irish whip into the corner. And now I think we're about to see a bit of synchronicity between Pain and Malice. No, Pain going for the Tree of Woe here. Oh, dead stomping right on the face and letting Billy crumple to the ring mat. Pain and Malice are cruel individuals. This really is a clashing of styles here. On one hand, you have Christina and Billy, two probably some of the more light-hearted, wholesome talents you'll ever see on any Intense Wrestling roster. Very good, you know, sisters, best friends, very, just a great team. Very capable of working together, ride and die type people, and will just look out for, they always look out for each other. And then on the other hand, you have Pain and Malice, who do not care about anyone but themselves, that get joy, that derive joy from causing pain to others, who have their own ways of causing pain to their opponents. Pain and Malice are terrifying. And I don't think you could get two more different sets of teams here. Now, right at the moment, Billy's been doing quite well against Pain, but Pain is back on her feet here. Billy a little bit quicker though, goes for the Irish whip, rushes over, and gets the clothesline this time. And Billy seems to be quite happy she finally got to land that clothesline. Oh, look at this. DDT from Billy. Nice work right there. Billy getting a show off her in-ring capabilities here. And now going for the arm here. Oh, going for a submission. as she works over the arms. That is gonna hurt. Do not underestimate Billy and Christina. Just because they got those really cuddly outfits on, it doesn't mean that they are not very capable in the ring. But now it's Pain and Malice's turn. Oh, here we go. Malice going up to the middle rope. Oh! That is nasty, but Billy, we're going to try and fight off Malice here. A series of striking blows, Irish whip. Oh, but Malice, unfazed, going for the fireman's carry. Billy trying to fight off Malice here, going for the drop kick. And she's going to try and keep Malice down. But the thing about Malice is Malice does not stay down. And a vicious elbow strike brings Billy to the ground. And now going to drag Billy over. Dragging her closer to the corner with Pain in. Keeping Billy away from her sister Christina. And trying to make sure that Billy cannot tag out. Oh, but Billy trying to fight back here. Going after Pain, but Pain with the Irish whip here. Rushes over. Oh, Pain cut it a little too short, and that allows Billy a chance to fight back here. Billy going for the Irish whip, tanking into the corner with Christina. Oh, but Pain gets out of the way. And now taking it back into the corner with Malice. And Pain. Oh, took too long. Pain likes to take it slow. She likes to exact her punishment slowly, but she took it too slowly there and allowed Billy the chance to come back here. But Pain is not fazed by the offense of Billy here. And now, gonna try once again into the corner with Malice. And now, we're gonna see a bit more teamwork. Look at this, holding Billy in place to work the arm over. But Billy continuing the fight back here. Snake eyes from Billy. Nice work there. And now, going over the leg here. Driving the leg into the ring mat. But Malice, unfazed by Billy. I think Billy is going to have to make the tag eventually, because there's only so long she can try and fight off two people here by herself. Oh, Malice rushes over and both knees right into the rib cage of Billy there. Oh, what is Malice planning? Malice is planning something. Goes for the snapmare. Oh, knee across the back. And tags in Pain once again. Malice not getting involved nearly as much as I think she would normally do. Something's going on here. But Pain now going after Billy. But Billy has had a chance to recover. And Billy going in for a nice clothesline right there. Now stomping away at Pain. And oh, look at this. Up and over with the leg drop. Good work there by Billy. And Billy getting right back in. Billy is doing a lot of work by herself at the moment. And I think she's finally going to try and tag in her sister Christina. Oh, here we go. Oh, look, it's Billy stomping a mud hole in Christina. And now tags in. Now Christina gets tagged in. Stomps a mud hole in Pain. Billy tags herself in now. And now going in with some more stomps to the chest. And once again, Christina, look at this. Synchronicity, boom, with a drop kick. And Billy and Christina in control of the matchup. And pinfall, two and a kick out. Pain is still in this one. Good work there by Billy, taking out Malice, by the way. Oh, but now it's between Pain and Christina here. Oh, and Pain not wasting any more time. She is getting serious about this now. Oh, look at this. Snake eyes from Pain. And when you're up against her, that's all you'll feel. Oh, just dissecting Christina here. And look at this, bringing Christina back up to her feet. But Christina! Going after Pain here. Oh, nice drop kick from Christina. Oh, nice Hurricane Rana there. And now Christina bringing Pain back up to her feet here. Picks up Pain. Nice work right there. Going for the pinfall. One, two, no. Only a two count. Billy trying to stop Malice from getting involved there. Doesn't need to, because Malice got right out of there, thank goodness. And now Christina, snap suplex. And now Christina, going for Payne, look at this. Backbreaker. Nice work by Christina, who is feeling very confident now. Going for the pinfall once again. One, two, and a kick out. Oh, kick to the back there. Christina taking Payne up. Oh, Payne raking the eyes. Oh! And that kick could have just knocked Christina out. Oh, Payne doesn't think it's enough, though. Look at this submission hold. And Christina could tap out right here, right now, trying to get free. Oh, series of knees there, and a punch. Manages to get herself free right there. But Payne quick to get back on the offensive here. Oh, what is Christina doing here? Oh, good Lord. No, Payne, you don't realize chickens are flightless birds. You can't do this. No, no, no. No, my God. No. And that is going to... Oh, my word. I'd be surprised if Christina isn't completely out now. Christina trying to fight back, but my word, you have to imagine the pain shooting through the spine right now from falling that far. The fans are commending the effort of Christina here to fight off pain despite everything, and she's doing a very good job, it must be said. But I think she needs to put this away now, because I imagine that the pain is starting to stack up, and it wouldn't be too long before this... Oh my goodness, caught into the ring post there. I don't even think that was the intention. Yeah, that wasn't the intention, but I imagine Christina's going to roll with it. Oh, but she's not going to get to, because Malice is back. Oh, Christina deflects Malice there. Scoop slam. And big elbow drop from Christina. Oh, could Christina get to pin Malice here? Oh no, Malice going to take Christina down. And Christina trying to find a way up, way to Billy, but oh, Malice is quick on the attack here. Oh, Christina with the arm drag here. Going after Malice here. Oh, what's Christina planning? Oh, a series of kicks there to the midsection, and a clothesline. Good work there, going for the pinfall. One. No, only a one count. Christina's going to have to hit a huge move if she wants to put away Malice here. Oh, and I think Christina, she's signaling that it's time to put this one away, and she's going to certainly give it a try here. Boom! And that could do it. That could do it. Oh, look at this. Pinfall. One, two, three. And Billy stopped Payne from breaking up. So Christina and Billy win this one. You know what I was saying about how Christina and Billy are extremely synchronized? I think you got to see a bit of that here. Oh, that was a wonderful match. Payne and Malice, if you haven't seen the past few episodes of Virtual Shop, you know why this is a huge victory for Christina and Billy. Both Payne and Malice have proven themselves to be extremely dangerous competitors. And so a victory for Christina and Billy here show why they are, in my opinion, a tag team to watch. Sisters getting a huge victory in this one. Now, Payne and Malice. I don't think they're going to be shedding too many tears, given that Payne could become a world champion soon. But, my oh my, what a match! Oh, doesn't hurt any less to watch when it's a replay. Ooh, outside superplex. But yeah, big congratulations to Christina and Billy, showing what they're capable of in the tag scene. Well, we're going to move on now, because we're going back to Mountaintop. Now, normally we'd end an episode here, but this is a special crossover episode, so it's longer than normal, and we've got triple threat action! Now, hey, let us know in the comment section below some of your favourite costumes. Please let us know, because we would love to hear it. Obviously, watch the episode all the way through to get a look at all of the costumes. But here comes another costume. The returning former world champion, Aaron Storm. Dressed up, wig and all, as Mr. Perfect. Now, for those who are unaware of what Aaron has been up to, now Aaron Storm, the leader of Storm System Worldwide, who we saw earlier with Thomas Swole, claimed to have been injured these past few weeks, and claimed that that's why Xander Horace was able to get the title off of him, and that the Reaper cannot touch him while he's injured. Well, Thomas Swole got the Reaper on his own, and Aaron Storm revealed his true colours by having a two-on-one assault. Aaron Storm is a despicable human being who will do whatever it takes to get his way. And he was successful this time around. But I don't think he'll be having the last laugh in this matter. But yeah, Aaron Storm dressed up as Mr. Perfect Kurt Hennig. And here comes Eli T. Can I just say that it's crazy how well the game has done, like, the lighting and texturing of objects. Because once I picked the right material and got the right colour, that just looks like a pumpkin. That looks way too much like a pumpkin. That is weird. But yeah, we got Eli T dressed as a pumpkin. He's got the colour of his clothes are a bit more orangey than normal. This is certainly weird. Now, Eli T, one half of the tag team champions, Kendrick Melandra, not going to be involved in action here tonight. But Eli T and Kendrick Melandra got the titles off of huge opponents in Hardcore Hank and Keller. Hardcore Hank being another former world champion. So Kendrick Melandra and Eli T, it certainly wasn't a fluke that they won the title, because they had to win a huge match in order to do that. Oh my word. Oh, and here comes one man who isn't in costume. If you can even call him a man, because I'm not even sure if he's human. It's Scarecrow. Now Scarecrow, the other man helping out the Reaper in the fight against the Storm System. Scarecrow is the most unpredictable. Black Death is supremely talented. Like, we have the leader, the Reaper, who has been a two-time world champion, one of the most dominant performers in intense wrestling. Then you have Black Death, who I think is extremely gifted and talented himself, and capable of taking on a litany of different talents. And then you have Scarecrow, who is unpredictable. Someone who I would not want to be making dealings with, but the Reaper clearly knows better than I do, but I would be too scared to want to make a deal with Scarecrow. Because just look at him! Look at him! Now the match begins. Eli T going for Aaron Storm. Now Aaron Storm actually has beef with both men in this triple threat match. You mentioned just now the whole thing with Scarecrow helping out the Reaper, who is trying to take on the Storm System. To explain that one, Aaron Storm actually injured the Reaper when cashing in Money in the Bank. And so now Reaper using his connections with the Dark Forces to try and take out the Storm System. Now the reason that Aaron has beef with Eli T is because, well, Aaron Storm used the tag team champions Showtime as muscle for the longest time, but because Aaron Storm would get into so much beef with people, it was causing Showtime to struggle to get to the titles, because they were dealing with so much shit. They were
caught in the crossfire because of Aaron. And Kendrick Melandra, sick and tired of it, wrote things off with Aaron and said that if they were to ever meet each other again, he would beat the hell out of Aaron Storm. Now, Eli T showing what he's capable of. Eli T definitely the muscle of the tag team champions, as he just dominates Aaron Storm and Scarecrow. And look at this, going for a submission hold, going for the arms. Scarecrow watching on here. And I think Scarecrow knows it's too early, and that Aaron Storm still had some life to give. Now, Aaron getting out of this, doesn't want to get involved. He wants to let Scarecrow and Eli T wear each other out in this matchup. And now Eli T picks up Scarecrow here. I mean, Scarecrow picks up Eli T here, my bad. Oh, Aaron Storm comes in with the drop kick. I've been commentating for over an hour. My throat is really dry. That's all I can think about right now. Oh, Scarecrow. Oh, goes for a big boot, but Eli T catches it. And now it's Eli T's turn. He goes for a single leg crab here. Scarecrow dragging himself over to the ropes, though, trying to make an escape. Oh, and manages to get enough leverage to get out. And Scarecrow closing in on Eli T here, clubbing the back. And now dragging Eli T over to the corner. But Eli T muscling out here. Aaron Storm now getting involved, trying to take on both at once. Oh, Eli tried to DDT Scarecrow, but Scarecrow managed to keep himself rock steady there. Oh, Aaron Storm there with the uppercut. Takes Eli T to the ground. Aaron Storm showing off his strength there with a military press slam. Bringing Eli T back to his feet, but Eli T getting right back on the offensive here. Oh, a back and forth now between Aaron and Eli T. Oh, Aaron Storm, deadlift powerbomb here. Showing off his strength, going for a pinfall here. One, two, oh! Scarecrow broke up the pin and took out the referee. This is what I was talking about. Scarecrow is unpredictable. Now, Scarecrow dealing with Aaron Storm now. Oh, gonna go for a big side slam. There are no survivors when Scarecrow is on the prowl. Now getting up Eli T, but Eli T with the spine buster. Referee now trying to get back up to his feet here. And now, oh, look at this, Eli T up on the top rope, and he finds and he misses. Scarecrow gets got out of the way of that one. And right at the moment, Scarecrow now back on the offensive. Irish whip. Oh, ducks under. Big boot takes Eli T to the ground. And then takes out Aaron with a big boot. And I'm surprised that pumpkin is holding up its integrity, by the way. Wow. But now Aaron recovering on the outside. Oh, Scarecrow knows what he must do. Takes Aaron out of the picture. Goes back after Eli T, going for a pinfall, but I don't think that's a wise idea. One count, it's only going to be a one count, because Eli T was stirring there. Eli T gets back up to his feet here, and big German suplex from Eli T. Now Eli T dragging Scarecrow over, going for a pinfall, but Aaron Storm is getting back into proceedings here. Breaks up the pin before the referee can even begin the count, and now Aaron has to deal with Eli T. And Eli T drives him legs first into the ring, man. That is going to hurt the knee there. Dragging Aaron Storm over to the center of the ring. But Eli T's not going to go for a pinfall. He's going to go for a monkey flip. Good work there by Eli T. Oh! Rear clothesline from Scarecrow, though. Takes down Eli T here. And now, going to go for the pinfall here. One, just a one count. Oh! Kick to the back there. And Scarecrow works over Eli T. Boom! Driving the knee down. Now Scarecrow wrenching on that pumpkin head of Eli T. Oh, that is agonizing. Now going for the pinfall, but Aaron Storm breaks it up. Oh, Aaron going for some attacks here. Oh, wait, Aaron. Aaron going for the finish, and Scarecrow neck first into the ropes. And that is going to do it. Unless Eli T gets up, I don't think he is. I think Aaron Storm has just gotten a victory here. Here we go. Pinfall. One. Two. No. And a kick out at two.
Scarecrow. The Dark Forces channeling through him, but Aaron Storm not wasting any time. He's getting right back on the offensive here. Oh. Now, normally, Aaron Storm would be flexing and showing off some more, but I think he knows what he's up against here. When he's got two people who consider him public enemy number one, Aaron Storm realised he couldn't do it. You know, he couldn't do anything, but right now, Aaron Storm out of the picture. Oh, Eli T with a knee to Scarecrow there. Now, Eli T going to go and pin Aaron Storm here. One, only a one count. But yeah, Aaron Storm, I think, realising he can't flex, he can't show off when he's got two people who hate him this much. Oh, ah, that's great work there from EIT. One, two, with a kick out. Two, Aaron Storm still in this one. Oh my goodness, EIT, definitely not nice himself as he rakes the eyes of Aaron Storm. But now Scarecrow going for a Boston Crab, and look at this. Aaron trying to find a time to show off, but I think he's realised he's got to rush over and gets and knocks Scarecrow silly so Eli T can escape. But now, Aaron getting Eli T out of the picture here. Scarecrow is back up, and now Aaron gonna capitalise. Oh, but Scarecrow getting right on the offensive here. Going for the pinfall. One, two, and a kick out at two. Now Scarecrow getting Aaron Storm back up to his feet here. Oh, and a big strike from Scarecrow. And Scarecrow, I think he's about to put this one away. Going for the pinfall here. One, two, no, kick out at two. Oh, big leg drop from Scarecrow to Aaron Storm. Going for the pinfall again, but Eli T coming in, breaks up the pin. And now Scarecrow is going to try and take on Eli T here. And doing a quite good job at it. Oh, but Eli T sends Scarecrow into the turnbuckle. Oh, no. Oh, no. Here it comes. The buckle bomb from Eli T. Now Eli T going to go and pin Aaron Storm here. One, two, and a kick out at two. Aaron Storm still in this one. Now you can tell just how bollocks Aaron Storm's injuries are that he's been able to fight this hard for this long after, you know, after claiming that his knees were screwed. Oh, look at this though. Eli T showing off his capabilities in the ring. Now Eli T going again for the pinfall, but Scarecrow's back up. Two, and Scarecrow breaks it up at 2.9. And takes Eli T into the corner with the clothesline. Now stomping a mud hole in Eli T here. Boom! Dropping Eli T right there. And now gonna go for a Boston Crab. But Eli T very quickly got himself to the ropes. But Eli T rolling himself to the outside. And Scarecrow gonna try and pin Aaron Storm here. One, two, and a kick out at two. Aaron Storm still in this one. He's not getting Booker T, that's for damn sure. Oh my goodness. Scarecrow trying to deal with Aaron, but Aaron's had a chance to recover, and now Aaron gonna try and take out Scarecrow here. Now, that is not gonna do a lot of offense, but Aaron trying to assert dominance here. Going for a pinfall regardless. Two, and a kick out from Scarecrow. But Eli T is back in now. And look at this, Eli T takes down Aaron Storm. Good work there by Eli T. Now Eli T gonna go and pin Scarecrow here. One, two, and a kick out at two. Once again, Scarecrow is still in this. Oh, but wrenching on the head here. Eli T doing what he can to take out Scarecrow now. Scarecrow though making his escape. And now a series of punches from Scarecrow. And a spine buster takes down Eli T. Now Aaron gets back up, but it might be too late. Two count, Eli T kicks out. Oh, Scarecrow grabs a hold of Aaron. Belly to belly. Just good work there by Scarecrow. Going for the pinfall now. One, two, no, a kick out from Aaron Storm. Oh, ooh. Aaron Storm makes the escape. Oh, takes down Aaron Storm. And an EYT sends Scarecrow plummeting to the outside. An EYT chasing after. Considering his next plan of action here, I imagine. Who does he go for? Does he go for Scarecrow or does he go for Aaron? I really should have brought a glass of water with me because my throat is not happy with me right now. Oh, now everyone's in the ring. And I think Eli T spent a little too long trying to think about his next plan. Oh, sent Scarecrow back to the outside. And Aaron was laughing and Eli T flipped on a dime right there. My word. Two and a kick out at two there. Aaron's still not laughing now. Aaron coming in with the spine buster. Going for the pinfall. One, two, and a kick out at two. And now Aaron bringing up Eli T, but Eli T takes Aaron Storm to the ground. Pinfall again. One, two. They really need to start hitting some big moves. They keep going for pinfalls, but they're not hitting the big moves. They hit the big moves earlier, but they still seem to be thinking that those big moves are still going to have enough residual force. Sure, it took out the opponents, but look, Eli T's realized, and now hitting a big move, and I think that might be it for Scarecrow. One, two, and a kick out. But that's the thing, when you hit a big move and it doesn't take someone out, that just means you've got to hit another big move. You can't be wasting your time going for pinfalls when it's not going to do anything. Aaron Storm keeping out of the way, doesn't want to get involved when these two are tearing each other apart. Because if they notice him, they'll tear him apart before each other. But now, look at that, Aaron standing on the sidelines once again, trying to keep out of the way to strike at the best opportunity. He might have picked a bad time though, because now he's got to deal with Eli T. Oh no, and he busts him open. Good Lord, throat first onto the top rope, and that is horrific. And I imagine he got busted open by going face first into the side of the ring there. But it's not going to matter because Scarecrow has taken out Aaron Storm. One, two, no! And the match continues. But I'd have said they should have pinned Eli T because Eli T is down. You could give him a 10 count. Oh, just as I say it. Can Eli hear me? Bloody hell. Oh, Eli T closing in on Scarecrow here. Oh, what's he doing? Oh no, not again. We saw this earlier. Eli T now going to do it. No! The outside superplex. And now Eli T, now he's got Scarecrow out of the picture. No, Eli, you've got something good here. Oh no, Eli T, he wants to take out everyone. But that's not the way to go about it in a triple threat match. Oh, now he's going for Aaron. But I think he waited too long. Aaron had a chance to recover. And now Aaron able to close in and potentially get the victory here. Oh, Eli T not going to let that happen though. Oh, look at this. Big powerbomb from Eli T. And now grabs a hold of Scarecrow, brings him down. Nice work there from Eli T. But it's not enough to stop Scarecrow. Scarecrow now going to go for the pinfall. One, two, and a kick out. Eli T is an incredibly strong competitor, and the fact that he can still keep coming back after everything is scary, especially after taking an alley-oop like that. Oh! The force of that Irish whip is scary. But Scarecrow kicks out right away. And that is scary as well in its own right. The fact that Scarecrow was able to do that. Now Aaron Storm clubbing away at the back. Oh, but Eli T not going to take any of that. Oh, back and forth now between them two. Oh, and Aaron Storm wins that one with the drop kick. Now Aaron bringing Eli T back up to his feet. Oh, good Lord. Oh! That is horrific. Requires a lot of strength. And that's purely why Aaron does a lot of these things. Because he wants to show off his strength. He believes he is the strongest man in intense wrestling. Now he's going to have to deal with Scarecrow though. Because Scarecrow now working over the shoulder of Aaron Storm. Look at this. Just working him over. But Aaron taking the leg out. Taking the leg out from his leg. Of Scarecrow. Oh, now Aaron Storm gonna focus. Oh. Oh my god! Oh my goodness. Now, I don't think he got that strength by legitimate means, but he might have a point to be claiming to be the strongest man on the roster. One, two, Eli T kicked out at two. Good lord. Aaron with the drop kick, though. And now he's feeling confident enough to start flexing. He thinks he's got this one in the bag. And I mean, I can't blame him. He is doing very well in this match. Oh, Eli T's back up though. Oh, Aaron a little bit faster, but Eli T unstoppable. And Eli T with a vicious clothesline right there. And now wrenching the head of Aaron Storm, tantalizingly close to the ropes, but not close enough for Aaron Storm to be able to reach them. But Aaron Storm making the escape. And he tries to run over, but Eli catches him in the spine buster. And now Scarecrow's back up. Oh, ankle lock from Eli T, but Scarecrow makes Eli break it up. Eli with a vicious kick to the head, takes Scarecrow to the ground. Eli T going for the pinfall here. Now one, two, the kick out at two. Eli T gonna have to hit yet another big move here if he wants to put away Scarecrow. Oh, I think he's just gonna get Scarecrow out of the picture entirely. Oh, good lord. Sunset flip, powerbomb to the outside, and Scarecrow is down and out. And now Eli T going back to focusing on Aaron Storm. But Aaron Storm has had a chance to recover, and Eli T could be in trouble now. Oh, nice work there by Eli T. Now Eli T looking down at Aaron Storm, looking to potentially put this one away. Big Eli T clothesline. Oh, boom with a backbreaker. But Scarecrow's back again. And Eli T knows what he needs to do to put away Scarecrow. Now, you have to imagine that he must be a little bit out of it, Eli T, after all the abuse he's got. Keep in mind, he is bleeding under that pumpkin. Oh, Scarecrow still in this one. But Eli T still fighting back here. A back and forth now. As these two are giving it everything they've got. Giving it, fighting till the bitter end. Ooh. Ho, ho. And now Scarecrow grabs the legs. Nice work there. Aaron Storm's back up though now. Ooh. Bad move by Aaron Storm there. Tried to take them both out, but took neither of them out. Oh, Aaron Storm now. Irish whip into the corner. Oh, what's Aaron's plan here for Eli T? Oh, good lord. Oh, wait, what is Aaron doing here? Wait, oh my goodness. Oh! That is brutal from Aaron Storm. And Eli T might be out of it here. Oh. Aaron and Scarecrow now getting into the ring. Eli T out of it at the moment. Aaron going to try and take care of Scarecrow, but Scarecrow coming in. And I think Scarecrow's about to put Aaron Storm away with the last ride. Here we go. One, two, three. And Scarecrow wins. Whoa. Now that was crazy. That was the longest match I think we've had tonight. My, that was a big match right there from three very hungry, high-level competitors. Scarecrow managed to get the victory. It was a very good place of right place, right time. Aaron was able to take out Eli T, and then Scarecrow was able to take out Aaron. my goodness. But there was some huge moves in this matchup. Several finishers and a buckle bomb, like several big moves throughout this match, as all three men looked to try and prove themselves in this match. But not only did Scarecrow get a win against a big opponent, I mean, it would have been big to pin one of the tag team champions, but he pinned a former world champion in Aaron Storm. Scarecrow and Black Death proving why they are to be feared in the ring. Now we're going to be seeing the leader of this trifecta, the Reaper, in the main event tonight. Can the Reaper continue this trend as he takes on the Phantom? That's going to be great, but we've got no time to waste. We're going to get right into the next matchup. We apologize, ladies and gentlemen. We don't know what happened to the feed there, but we're moving on to a fatal four-way match now. Back to Virtual Shock. Now, I'm sure you're noticing there's a lot more Virtual Shock and Mountaintop matches than there are Genesis matches, and that's just because, quite frankly, there's more scary acts in Mountaintop and, well, in Virtual Shock than there is in Genesis. Just the way the dice is rolled sometimes. We do have another match though with Genesis, and you will be seeing that very soon. But here comes the Forsaken. We mentioned her earlier. The Forsaken went up against Plague Princess in the Global Championship Tournament, which she ended up losing. But you've got to be careful when you face the Forsaken, because she is a very physically dominant performer. Now, the Forsaken, formerly known as Jackie Thompson, was a tag team partner with the current Women's Money in the Bank holder, Isabella Violet. Now, we're gonna wait and see now as... But yeah, the Forsaken has two of the most brutal finishers with a punt kick being one of them. But here comes Sandra Davies. Sandra Shark Davies, though this week she's Sandra Mummy Davies. Now, Sandra Davies was also in one of the tournaments. I believe it was the World Championship Tournament, but she lost to former Women's World Champion Dusk. But she is also in the Tag Team Tournament with Minnie Taylor, and they've been doing quite well. They're in the Grand Finals, in fact. Sandra and Minnie are in the Grand Finals of the Tag Team Tournament. Speaking of people in the tournament, here comes Donna Schmidt, who is in the World Title Tournament, and in fact, will be facing said former world champion Dusk. So, if Donna wants to keep her name in the world title picture, she's going to have to beat one of the best. And that'll be next week. Stay tuned for that one. Payne and Donna both have their work cut out for them. Payne's got to fight the current world champion. Donna has to fight the former world champion. It's going to be very interesting to see how that pans out. Now, Donna dressed up as a zombie this year for Halloween. My word, this is going to be a very interesting fatal four-way, that's for damn sure. And here comes the fourth person, the latest signing to Intense Wrestling's Virtual Shop. It's Ellis Savage, dressed up as Shantae from the video game series Shantae. And she is ready. Now, she's putting another is a wig. Ellis actually has much shorter hair than a lot of the other women on the roster. But, yeah, she looks the part. Very good costume right there. Now, Ellis Savage, a very capable competitor in the ring. Very, very technically capable, and I think could do herself very well here. Unfortunately, not in any of the championship tournaments
but
I think deserves an opportunity in the future. Ellis Savage very, very ready for this one now. It's very weird that her debut is on Halloween in an outfit as Shantae, but that's just the way things work sometimes. Well, here we go. We got three people in costumes, and then we got the Forsaken who isn't in costume. That's just how the Forsaken always looks. Like something out of Mad Max. Oh, and the Forsaken taking out Donna Schmidt there. Meanwhile, Ellis Savage going for Sandra Davies here. And now, the Forsaken working over the arm of Donna Schmidt. Oh, and look at that, Sandra Davies with the fireman's carry to Ellis Savage. And picks up Ellis Savage here. Takes her over to the steel steps. Boom! Face first into her. That is going to hurt. Meanwhile, Donna Schmidt trying to take on the Forsaken here in this matchup. Rushes over. Nice rear clothesline. Now working the leg over. Boom! Nice work right there. Meanwhile, Sandra Davies is doing quite well against Ellis Savage here. Oh, Donna Schmidt. Nice suplex right there. Now, Donna Schmidt, wife of GHK's very own Trevor Schmidt. And both Donna and Trevor, two high-level talents. Oh, Ellis breaks the pin out there. Ellis very quick here. Now, Sandra. Nice German suplex into a pinfall. One. Just a one count. Ellis quickly kicks out. Now, the Forsaken with some stiff strikes sends Donna tumbling to the outside. Meanwhile, Sandra working over Ellis Savage, going for the pinfall here. One, just the one count. Ellis quickly kicks out there. Oh, the Forsaken takes down Sandra there. I almost forgot that was Sandra because she's just so, there's so much of her covered up there. Oh, Donna tries to go for crossbody, but Ellis gets out of the way. And now Sandra looking to go back after Ellis here. Irish whip over the ropes. Ellis clinging on here. Oh, but meets a stiff punch from Sandra Davies. And meanwhile, Donna Schmidt doing quite well against the Forsaken here. Oh, nice drop kick sends the Forsaken into the corner. And right now, Donna Schmidt. Oh, Donna Schmidt has some plans here for the Forsaken. Goes for a bulldog and a stiff kick on the outside from Ellis Savage. Takes down Sandra Davies here. Elbow from Donna Schmidt takes down the Forsaken here. And now Ellis Savage going to go for a backdrop pinfall from Donna Schmidt. But only a one count. The Forsaken extremely tough. Not going to go down that easily. Oh, face first. Great work there from Donna Schmidt. Donna Schmidt going for the legs, but the Forsaken gets back up. Oh, look at that! The Forsaken doing very well in this match, I've got to say. Now Ellis Savage also doing quite well, showing what she's capable of as she takes out Sandra Davies. But Donna Schmidt managing to fight back against the Forsaken inside the ring. It's like we're watching two different matches at the moment. And Donna Schmidt showing that while she isn't as strong as the Forsaken, she's definitely more capable in the ring. Meanwhile, Ellis Savage doing some nice offense, taking out Sandra Davies. Now getting back into the ring to take out the Forsaken and Donna Schmidt. Now we're seeing what Ellis Savage is capable of here. Gets the arm, nice hammerlock, Donna Schmidt with the elbow gets herself out of it, and a nice spinning heel kick. And Sandra Davies in the ring, Forsaken in the ring, and the Forsaken going to try and deal with Sandra. Oh, that's brutal. Big knee there from Ellis Savage, by the way. And now the Forsaken going after Ellis Savage. And look at this full Nelson slam. The power of the Forsaken coming through in this match. Oh, a big leg drop right there. Dragging Ellis Savage. Oh, wait, no. Realised about Donna Schmidt. But Donna quick to strike. And now Donna going for Ellis Savage here. Donna going to try and put Ellis Savage away here, I imagine. But Sandra is back in now. And Sandra trying to strike, but Donna gets out of the way. Donna, she's been learning. She's continuously learning and improving, and she wasn't going to be taken out that easily, but the 2-on-1 was too much in the end for her. And now, look at this. Sandra Davies going to try and take out Ellis Savage here.
big elbow, but Ellis gets out of the way, and my word, that is going to hurt Sandra. Meanwhile, good work there by Ellis, who has done some, doing on a big suplex right there. And now Ellis, looking to pull away Donna Schmidt. Sandra in Forsaken, meanwhile, brawling on the sidelines. Oh, we're about to see two finishes here. Boom from Ellis, and boom from Sandra, and from the Forsaken. Blech. That wasn't one of the Forsaken's finishes. I forgot that's I think Forsaken's signature. Still, Ellis going for the pinfall. No! Donna kicks out. Meanwhile, Sandra taking on Sling Blade to the Forsaken. So there's a lot to keep track of here. And my throat is really starting to give out on me here after 1 hour, 40 minutes. Oh, we're about to see another finish here. There we go, the second finish. Oh, that Pele kick was great and has taken out the Forsaken. Meanwhile, Donna Schmidt. Oh, good lord, we saw this before from Donna. Donna's going to go coast to coast to Ellis Savage. Oh, and Ellis is down. But the Forsaken now closing in on Donna Schmidt. Donna Schmidt not going to let that happen. Goes for crossbody, but the Forsaken gets out of the way. Oh, but Donna unfazed. Nice drop kick. Ellis is completely out of it. Oh, she's getting back up to her feet here. The Forsaken's down. Sandra's recovering. Both Sandra and the Forsaken are recovering at the moment. And Donna sees Ellis, and I think I know what she's going to go for here. No, Ellis gets out of the way. Oh. Oh, backstabber from the Forsaken. Goes for the pinfall here. Oh, Sandra just barely breaks up the pin. And now the Forsaken. Oh no, oh no, oh no, Donna. Ah, the punt kick. Good lord, the Forsaken with one of the most brutal finishes of all time. And now, look at this. Spear from Sandra Shark Davies. The harpoon was fired. We're seeing a lot of finishes here tonight. I don't know if the Pele kick is actually one of Sandra's finishes. I've actually forgotten. Oh, wait a minute. Donna saw the opportunity too. Oh, and Sandra just barely breaks it up. But oh, a stunner from Donna Schmidt. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Finisher City population. All four of these women. Oh my God. That was a stellar matchup from all four of these women. Ellis Savage showing what she's capable of. I'm very excited to see what she brings in the, you know, in the future to the Virtual Shock. If this is matches anything to go by, then we got to see more of the performances from Sandra, who is consistently proving to be a very capable athlete. And we've finally got to see what the Forsaken is capable of. And the Forsaken, one of the most brutal movesets in the women's division. But in the end, Donna Schmidt, her learning, her improving is really starting to pay off. Her awareness of everything going in the ring, she may not be the strongest, but she's very quickly proving to be one of the smartest in the ring. We're going back to Mountaintop once again, and it's Hubert Constantine versus Hardcore Hank in singles action. Oh, God, here we go. Here comes GHK's Hubert Constantine. Oh, this is stupid. I want to let you... This is daft. This is really daft. But here is Hubert Constantine. He's ready. Oh, I don't think I am, though. I think I'm going to need a rest after this. Oh, my goodness. Now, Hubert Constantine, the current GHK World Champion, won it at IW Finale, the King of the Mountain right now. That's a mountain that's had people like Genesis's newest signing, the Nightmare, the person who he won it from, Trevor Schmidt, Rebellion, and many more, I imagine, hopefuls. Oh, Hubert Constantine has a lot of people now
Like, Cuban has a huge target on his back and has a lot of people gunning for him. And it's really hard to talk about how serious and how big a deal Hubert Constantine is when he looks like Homer Simpson. Jesus Christ. I love this. I probably will do more holiday specials like this, but please let me know in the comments below if you want to see more like this, because these are a lot of fun. Oh. And here comes former Intense Wrestling World Champion, Hardcore Hank. Hardcore Hank in the World League Tournament. He won the last World League Tournament. Hardcore Hank, one of the most capable wrestlers in the world. Not the nicest person ever. He's incredibly cruel, evil, vindictive, but he's so capable in the ring that he can get away with it. I don't condone his actions, but who the hell's gonna tell him no when he has been a former world champion and he's a former tag team champion? Hank is scarily effective. And I just want to let you know that thanks to Disney buying both Marvel and The Simpsons, this is a Disney on Disney battle. I just want you to know that. Whew! Hubert Constantine is my favourite Disney princess. There we go. I've made the joke. IW is not owned by Disney, by the way. Just want to let you know that. I mean, if Disney wants to make any offers, you know, send a couple million my way, I'll happily retire. Oh, Jesus. But yeah, Hank collecting tiles like they are Infinity Stones. Oh, my goodness. I'm getting lightheaded. Oh, Hank working is just dominating Hubert Constantine in this matchup. Oh, driving the knee into Hubert Constantine. Bringing Hubert back up to his feet. But Hubert taking the leg out of Hardcore Hank here. But Hank immediately springing back up. And Hank here gonna go and drive Hubert Constantine headfirst into the ring mat. Big leg drop from Thanos Hank. Oh! Look at this. Did you ever think you'd see Thanos versus Homer Simpson? This is like something you'd see at a bloody death battle. Oh, Homer though. Hey, Hubert though, taking Hank to the outside. Oh! That is a vicious backdrop from Hubert Constantine. Oh, but Hank with a knee. And you've got to be careful with the knees from Hank, because his knees can take you out. Don't believe me? Trust me, you'll find out. If you subscribe to Intense Wrestling, you will anyway. Now, they've got to be careful that they don't get counted out here in this matchup. There's a count of six at the moment. Face first into the side of the ring. Hubert, you're not on GHK. Get Hank into the ring. There we go. Now back into the ring here. And Hubert going after Hank. But Hank back on the offensive. Oh, driving the arm across the shoulder. Irish whip against the ropes. Oh, Hubert deflects it. But Hank is not going to let that stop him. Look at this. Boom. Driving the leg down with that famouser. Hubert getting right back into this though. And now Irish whip from Hubert Constantine. Oh, trying to go for a clothesline, but I think Hank just barely got out of the way of that one. And now, look at that! Beautiful, beautiful suplex there from Hardcore Hank. Ah, oh, driving the knee to the back of the head. And Hank is just dominating at the moment. Oh, snapping the neck. And now, oh, kicking the back of the leg here. Oh, this is not looking good for Hubert Constantine at the moment, that is for certain. Oh, nice work there by Hubert. Hubert's going to look for a big move here. He's going for a powerbomb. Boom, jackknife powerbomb from Hubert Constantine. But Hank is immediately getting back up to his feet here. So Hubert, clothesline, trying to take out Hardcore Hank here. Now, hopefully, going to keep him down. Oh, Hubert going to look to put this one away here. Look at this. Oh, Nelson Slam! And that is going to do it. Here we go. One, two, no! And Hubert can't believe it. I'd say I can't believe it, but this is Hardcore Hank here. Hardcore Hank is terrifying. Oh no. You know how I said you got to be careful of Hank and his knee? Here it comes. The knee! And Hubert Constantine is out. One, two, three. And Hardcore Hank wins. A huge victory for Hardcore Hank in this one as he beats the GHK World Champion. Pinfall there. Now, I thought Hubert might have been able to get a victory there, but Hank is seemingly unstoppable. I think Hank could very well win a second World League tournament.
It would not surprise me with the way that Hardcore Hank can be sometimes.
Well, he's certainly very, very happy with himself, is Hardcore Hank. Oh, God. Hardcore Hank doesn't need a costume. He's terrifying on his own. But Thanos Hank wins a huge match here, beating Hubert Constantine. Could he beat IW's world champion, Xander Horus, at the World League pay-per-view? You'll have to tune into that to find out. We're moving on to the final match from Intense Wrestling Virtual Shock now. It's Ruby Bourne, Hope Halliwell, and Sophia Muller in a triple threat match. Now we've got two Pokemon outfits and then Sophia Muller, who isn't in an outfit at all. We'll display that in a moment. But here comes the first woman of the match. It's Hope Halliwell, dressed up as a Curlia from Pokemon. And, I mean, it works. My word, that's surprisingly well done. I mean, it surprisingly fits. Well, Hope Halliwell, I mentioned her earlier, did have face a minor injury from Untouchable, but she's been cleared to compete. Now, when it comes to Hope, she wrestles a style unlike anyone else. She's actually one of the smallest competitors in Intense Wrestling, but she's also incredibly fast. Now, normally when I say a wrestler's incredibly fast, you usually see them running around. They'll usually do like 50 flips. Not the case here. Hope Halliwell, just incredibly good at dodging and going in for strikes. It's hard to describe, but if you ever watch a Hope Halliwell match, you'll probably see what I mean. Anyway, here comes Ruby Bourne, dressed up as a Monferno. Now, I want to explain that one. Ruby Bourne said that last year she was dressed as a Chimchar, and next year she's going to be an Infernape, but she wants to dress up as a series of different fire-type Pokemon, saying that those are her favorites. Now, Ruby Bourne, one of the fastest competitors, and this is more in the sense that you would normally expect. Ruby Bourne, incredibly speedy, incredibly aggressive, just unleashes a litany of strikes in the ring. Very, very capable, and Ruby Bourne in the tag team tournament, going to be in the tag team title match against Minnie Taylor and Sandra Davies. Ruby's partner being one of the larger members of the Intense Wrestling roster in Moxie. Yeah, what I was saying with Hope Halliwell is, her speed is used more to dodge maneuvers and, be incredibly hard to hit and just keep on going with strikes on her own. Maybe less hard hitting than other competitors, but slowly over time she can whittle her opponents down. Meanwhile, here comes the women's champion, Sophia Muller. I've just mentioned Hope Halliwell's strategy, I mentioned Ruby Bourne's strategy. Now I'm going to mention Sophia Muller's strategy. Sophia Muller's strategy is, she is one of the strongest powerhouses in the ring. Someone who I think could take on anyone, man or woman. Sophia Muller's strategy is simply to break you. Now I mentioned that Sophia Muller isn't in costume. And unlike everyone else who wasn't in costume, she's not a spooky act. She's not like Black Death, Chosen One, and whatnot, who is a normally spooky act. Not like Plague Princess, Scarecrow and whatnot. So why isn't she in costume? Well, Sophia Muller put it simply. She said that she is the scariest thing that these women have in their lives. She is the thing. She is the thing that none of these women want to. You know, when she is the thing that these women see in their nightmares. She doesn't see why she needs to wear a costume when she is the scariest thing that anyone who steps in the ring with her will ever see. A little less lighthearted than Ruby Bourne and Hope Halliwell, who have dressed up as Pokemon, but Sophia Muller is a terrifying individual. Whew. Now, Sophia Muller going to be fighting Payne next week in the World Championship match. Now, here we go. This match is going to get brutal. Any match with Sophia Muller is guaranteed to be brutal. Now, Hope Halliwell going for Sophia Muller here. Now, Sophia being hit with a series of blows, but oh, nice knee strike from Sophia Muller. Oh, and this is what I was on about with Hope Halliwell. Very easily dodging moves and going in with strikes of her own. Now, Ruby Bourne coming in with a series of knee strikes to take down Hope Halliwell. And now Ruby Bourne going after Sophia Muller, but Sophia easily taking down Ruby Bourne. And you think about how I just mentioned how Ruby Bourne is very close to being, to potentially being a, the first United Team champion in the women's roster. And you think about how Sophia Muller was just dominating her a second ago. Now Ruby Bourne getting some offense in. Oh, stomping a mud hole in Sophia. But now Hope Halliwell coming in. And Hope Halliwell now with a series of strikes of her own. Good work there by Hope Halliwell right now. Doing quite well in this. But Ruby Bourne pushes her away and comes rushing in. Oh, little cuts it short there with the knee strikes. So Hope was able to come in with a farmer's carry and a nice stiff kick there. Takes down Ruby Bourne. But now Sophia Muller going after Hope Halliwell here. Oh, and a series of stiff strikes. Now, the thing with Sophia Muller is her finisher is the Kimura. Now, if you don't know what the Kimura is, it's an arm hold. Oh, big vicious clothesline there. The Kimura is an arm hold, which if it's put on tightly, can break your arm. Now, Helen Munro took one of those, and it was not pretty. It really was quite nasty. Let me just double check my notes here. Sorry, just double checking here. When did they fight each other? Sophia Muller fought Helen Munro on episode 5, and Helen Munro at the moment is out with an arm injury because the referee called for the rope break, so Sophia Muller went full tilt with the Kimura, and I believe that Helen Munro has a hairline fracture now on the arm. So Helen Munro now recovering thanks to the brutal display from Sophia Muller, who is right now dominating this matchup, deadlifting Hope Halliwell here. Boom! With a powerbomb. Ruby Bourne watching on in horror at what Sophia Muller was doing to Hope Halliwell here. Now, Ruby Bourne's turn to get beaten up by Sophia Muller. Oh, stiff kick to the gut. And it seems like neither of these two women are able to take on Sophia Muller here. Hope Halliwell getting back up to her feet. But look at this. Sophia Muller deadlifting Ruby Bourne. Oh, and stiff elbow strike staggering Hope Halliwell here. Sophia Muller just murdering her opponents here. Sophia Muller does not care about the safety of her opponents, as by the fact that, oh, so these two are having to do whatever they can to take on Sophia and just try to survive. Oh, but now that Sophia is out of the picture, these two are going to focus on each other. Nice work there by Hope Halliwell. And Ruby back up on her feet here. And look at this, Ruby going for the arm. Boom, snapping the arm over the shoulder. And now, just working the arm over, just twisting the arm. But Sophia Muller's back in this now. Ruby, not realizing, trying to go for the pinfall, but Sophia broke it up. Now Ruby rushing over, takes down Sophia with the clothesline. And Ruby, I think she's starting to feel a little bit confident here. She's going to try and take Sophia on here, and a series of punches to the midsection seems to be doing the trick. Sophia's back up though. Ow! Clothesline from hell from Sophia Muller. One, two, no. Rudy's still in this one. And Sophia Muller gonna just get right back in this. Oh, Hope takes out Ruby. Hope takes out Ruby. And Sophia now gonna try and take out Hope here. Sends Hope tumbling to the outside. Sophia Muller bringing Hope Halliwell to her feet, but Hope Halliwell with an arm drag. Oh, and a stiff kick. Taking down Sophia Muller here. Oh, Sophia Muller not even shaken. As Sophia takes Hope, oh, and slams her face first into the LED board. Unlike Untouchable, who decided to show a little bit of mercy to Hope Halliwell, Sophia would never show that same kindness. Oh, Ruby, though, taking down Sophia Muller. Saying, that's quite enough. You've done enough beating up of Hope Halliwell. Try taking me on now. And now Ruby gonna try and, you know, well, like I just said, try and take me on, Sophia. Well, Sophia seems to be down, so now Ruby gonna focus on Hope, bringing her to her feet here. But Hope now with the arm drag. And sends Ruby face first into the steel ring post. Oh, that is going to knock Ruby completely out. And now Hope Halliwell going for Sophia Muller. Bringing Sophia up to her feet here. Oh, stiff kick there. And into the steel steps. But Sophia is right back to her feet. And now picks up Hope, but Hope gets out of the way. And this is the thing with Hope. Hope is slipperier than a bar of soap in the shower. Whoa! But Sophia still managing to keep a hold of Hope here. Just scary. Sophia taking Hope back into the ring here. Oh, boom! Face first into the side of the ring. And now Sophia gonna deal with Ruby Bourne here. But Ruby gonna try and fight back here. They call a warrior for a reason. Oh, look at this. Oh, chest just though. But I think despite being a warrior, Ruby, I think, is just severely outgunned in this one. Oh. Going to go for a pinfall here. One, two, breaks up the pinfall there. Hope breaks up the pin. Hope now going to go for a pinfall. Sophia breaks up the pin. I think Ruby's out of the picture, though. I think she's out of it. Oh! Did we just see? Oh my god! I think Hope's trying to low-key Sophia Muller! Is it successful though? One, two, three! Hope just low-keyed Sophia Muller! What? Well, that was a shocker! Oh my word! We've reached the 2-hour mark now. My, oh my! Well, that was the last women's match, and that was not what I was expecting. We saw Sophia Muller constantly dominating throughout this match, but the offense from Ruby and Hope, I think over time, whittled Sophia down, and then that last kick to the head was enough to keep Sophia down, which I did not expect to see. Now, Hope Halliwell with a huge victory. I don't know what this says. Does this mean that we could be seeing Sophia Muller be dethroned next week? Because if Hope can do it, surely Payne can? Well, we'll have to find out next week. Stay tuned next week for more Intense Wrestling Virtual Shock. Next up, we got Genesis. Oh God, I hope this episode ends soon, but we're into a 5-man match now in Intense Wrestling's Genesis. Let's get right into the action. Whew, we've had some interesting matches, I've got to say, here tonight. There's been some great matches. I think this has been a great, like, while this has been a lot of fun with all the costumes, we've got Leo dressed up as Rey Mysterio. We've had some interesting matchups, but I've got to say, this has also, I think, been a great showcase of all three Intense Wrestling shows for those who maybe haven't watched all three. So if you've ever not watched Mountaintop, or you've never watched Genesis, or you've never watched Virtual Shop, I hope this has shown you the level of talent each show brings. Now Leo, in the Limitless Championship hunt, managed to get out of the redemption round and is still in this. Oh good lord, I didn't realize he was in this fight, man. No, wait. Are you sure we got this right? You didn't invite him from GHK, did you? I need better agents. Good lord. Now, if you're not familiar with this creature, this is imperfect Isaac Kinley from GHK. Now, sometimes I'll say an act is sadistic. Sometimes I'll say a person is sadistic. Sometimes I'll say they're cruel, they're malevolent, they're evil. But if you were to take all those people, sieve out all the humanity from them, so there's only the pure evil, the pure hatred, the pure cold-heartedness, you would be left with this sadistic Isaac Kinley. He is a scary, deranged individual. Why is he here? I know we said we were inviting GHK talents. Yeah, I know he's a scary talent. Why the hell would you invite him though? Oh, Jesus. Oh lordy, this is... I sometimes regret our partnership with GHK. Oh god. This is gonna be horrific. This is gonna get brutal. Isaac Kinley matches are always devastating matches to watch. The best thing you can do when you're up against in a match with Isaac Kinley is just stay the hell away from him. Because it's not about winning a match with Isaac Kinley. It's about surviving a match with Isaac Kinley. Ooh. Good lord. I would have said the same thing with Sophia Muller in the previous match, but like Isaac Kinley, it's for a different reason. Sophia Muller will break your arms. Isaac Kinley will gouge your eyes out. Like, Jesus. Oh, God. Isaac Kinley is so much that even, like, Sam, the commentator of GHK, finds him to be bloody creepy. Oh, dear. Has he edged immortal into... Oh, what the hell? Into his throat? Jesus Christ. It's Samuel the Savior. He's dressed as... This match has been made so much better already. Oh my god. Come on, Samuel, you gotta win this. Please, that'd be fucking great. That would be amazing. Oh my goodness, having Isaac Rand's been just made worth it by this. Oh, good lord. It's one of GHK's newest signings. It's Menace. Now, I've heard Menace is a second generation superstar. Obviously, I haven't dared go near Menace to ask him more about that. But Menace certainly looks like he has a chip on his shoulder. Good lord. GHK, they certainly have some interesting talents, though, we must say. Like, good lord. Oh, he is terrifying. Not as terrifying as Isaac, but Jesus. Well, we're now waiting for the fifth and final man of this match. And here comes the Golden Phoenix, dressed up
has the greatest Mexican legend of all time, El Santo. Oh, here we go. Golden Phoenix paying tribute to one of the most legendary figures in Mexican wrestling history. In fact, in Mexican history, I'd say El Santo ranks up there, at least in my opinion. If you don't know who El Santo is, I recommend you watch a video about El Santo because I definitely think it is worth the watch. My, oh my. Well, anyway, here comes the Golden Phoenix. Oh my word. This is interesting. We got some very, like, this is a very interesting one. On one end, we've got two of the creepiest acts I've ever seen in Menace and Isaac Kinley. We've got Samuel dressed as Pepsi Man. Then we got Leo and the Golden Phoenix paying tribute to two great masked wrestlers. Ooh! And funnily enough, Golden Phoenix and Leo hate each other after Leo betrayed the Golden Phoenix before. So, of course, Golden Phoenix is going to go straight for Leo, and Leo is going to go straight for Golden Phoenix. Meanwhile, Pepsi Man squaring off against the two scares. Oh, what a super kick there from Menace. Oh, Leo takes Golden Phoenix down. Oh, rapes him across the middle rope. Not going to go for a 619. I don't think he's going to give the fans that. Oh, Menace there with the Hurricane Rana driving Isaac's head into the ring mat. Oh, and a big knee from the Golden Phoenix. Meanwhile, Menace sends Isaac Kinley to the outside. Pepsi Man. Oh, taken down by El Santo. The Golden Phoenix. I can't even say Samuel because I just see Pepsi Man. That might be the best, one of the best outfits in my opinion. Once again, leave a comment down below. Let us know some of your favourite Halloween outfits that you saw here tonight, because I'd love to hear which ones you like the most. Oh, here we go. Pepsi Man taking out Leo here. Meanwhile, Isaac Kinley stomping on the arm of Menace. Ooh, Isaac Kinley smacking both sides of the head there. Oh, Isaac Kinley. Oh God, what's he planning? Oh good Lord! Leg across the head there. And Isaac Kinley dissecting Menace at the moment. Menace kicks out though. Now everyone's getting back into the ring. Everyone is rushing into the ring. Oh! Pepsi Man takes down Leo. Oh, but a Hinzagiri takes down Pepsi Man. Samuel, my word. Oh, Menace with a nice short arm clothesline. Takes down Isaac Kinley. Pepsi Man getting back in now. I keep saying Pepsi Man, I can't say Samuel anymore. Oh, Leo takes down the Golden Phoenix here. And Leo with a standing moonsault. Oh, trying to go after Isaac, but Isaac got out of the ring there. Isaac Kinley's kick to the midsection. Oh, Golden Phoenix, meanwhile, dealing with Leo. Oh, good God, did you see the force of the kick from Isaac Kinley to Menace there? But Menace unfazed. Meanwhile, Golden Phoenix middle rope. Look at this. Oh! Leo managed to get out of the way of that one. That would have hit so hard if it had connected. Now look at this from Leo. Nice work there to take down Golden Phoenix. But now Samuel the Saviour. There we go, finally said it. Taking on Leo. Oh! Takes down Leo. Glancing blow, didn't get all of it, but still enough. Meanwhile, Isaac Kinley took out Menace and now taking out the Golden Phoenix. Oh, Samuel the Saviour taking Leo over to the ropes. And takes Leo out. Oh, good Lord, he's going to fly. He's going to fly. Oh, both knees to the rib cage. Now, Gold Phoenix takes out Isaac Kinley there. And now, nice standing moonsault from the Gold Phoenix. Meanwhile, Samuel the Saviour going to, boom, take out Leo. Kick out from Isaac Kinley there. Oh, now, oh, Samuel takes out Menace. Isaac Kinley gets out of the way of Golden Phoenix's offense. Now Isaac Kinley with the Irish whip sends
Dolph Phoenix to the side of the ring. Oh, good lord. Meanwhile, look at Samuel here. Nice elbow drop to Menace. And now going to deal with Leo. But Leo, nice takedown there. And now Leo, what's he going to do to Sammy the Savior? Nothing, because Sammy the Savior is powered by Pepsi. Oh, good lord. Oh, Dolph Phoenix takes out Isaac Kinley on the outside. Meanwhile, Leo took out Samuel, and now has taken out Menace. Oh, Menace recovering in the corner, but it looks like Leo's going to take advantage of that here. Nice work there by Leo. Leo going to go for a pinfall here. One, two, and a kick out. Menace is still in this one. Everyone rushing back into the ring now. Oh, good work here. Series of kicks from the Dolph Phoenix. Takes down Samuel. And now, oh, Samuel catches the leg and delivers one of his own, taking Dolph Phoenix right out of the picture yet again. Now, Dolph Phoenix also in the Dolph Phoenix and Leo in the Limitless title picture still. Samuel was just taken out of it last week, thanks to Ace the Tank Barkey. Was a very, very close match, however, I must say. Samuel did surprisingly well. Isaac and Menace you'll be seeing on GHK when it returns from its hiatus. Back first into the steel barricade. Isaac Kinley just doing what he does best, and that is decimating his opponents. Meanwhile, Menace looks to take out Samuel the Savior. Now, I always said that Samuel runs around like a superhero, but he's dressed as one now, the greatest superhero of all time in Pepsi Man. Dolph Phoenix coming in. Oh, Isaac not going to let that happen. He wants Pepsi Man all to himself. Oh, good lord. Wait a minute. Menace is going to put it away. Oh, and Leo's out. Leo rolling out of the ring as he knows he would have been done for. Meanwhile, now, Golden Phoenix waiting for Samuel. Here we go. Oh, and he catches Isaac with the drop kick. Isaac was in the way. Samuel decided to improvise. Golden Phoenix decided to improvise. Couldn't go for Samuel, so took out Isaac. Sorry, I'm really starting to... This has been a long show. Wow. Now Menace grabs a hold of Golden Phoenix. Picks him up, muscles him up. I'd definitely say Menace is the most physically dominant in this match. Now going for Samuel the Savior here. Samuel trying to recover in the corner. Isaac's back in now. Oh, good lord, though. Menace takes down Samuel the Savior. And now Isaac going to square off against Menace here. But Menace, so physically dominant, going to just overpower Isaac. But Isaac, oh, trying to go for a clothesline, but Menace managed to deflect it. Oh, nice catch, though, there from Isaac. And now Isaac choking out. Good lord. Menace might be out of it. He might be unconscious. Oh, nice tiger suplex there from the Golden Phoenix. Oh, good lord, Leo. You're in trouble, mate. Oh, diving headbutt from Isaac Kinley. Meanwhile, Samuel the Savior. Oh, Leo. Golden Phoenix does that. And Samuel with the DDT through the eye of the needle. Pepsi Man. Oh, this match certainly is awesome. We're seeing what Genesis can do here tonight. My, oh my. Oh, that Golden Phoenix trying to deal with Leo at the moment. Oh, Spanish Fly on the outside from Samuel the Savior, taking down Menace here. Look at this. Everyone's gunning for Leo at the moment. Tree of Woe, Leo being draped over the ropes. Oh, good lord, Isaac. Isaac, no, good grief, don't do this. Oh, Lord, I don't like Leo either all that much after what he did to the Golden Phoenix. But I think this is a bit too much. Oh, Isaac's flying. Oh, good God. And Leo, I think he's out. Good God almighty. He's rolling out of the ring again to try and recover. Meanwhile, Isaac and Menace gonna brawl on the outside. Golden Phoenix not sure what to do in this situation. He's coming over. He wants a piece of the action now. He's gonna go for Samuel though. Bringing Pepsi Man up to his feet here. Gonna send it back into the ring. Oh, everyone's coming back into the ring, except for Leo, who's still recovering on the outside. And Golden Phoenix, you know, calling to the fans, calling to his fans, but Pepsi Man starts to come back here. And look at this, Samuel takes out Golden Phoenix, will take down Golden Phoenix, takes out Isaac Pinfall, one! No, kick out, oh, not kick out, break up from Golden Phoenix. Oh, crucifix from Samuel the Savior. But now got to deal with Isaac, and Isaac comes in. Hurricane Rana spiking his head into the mat. And now Isaac, all gone Phoenix is out of the way. And now Isaac gonna try and deal with the, oh, Gold Phoenix caught in a very bad situation there. Vicious DDT into the hard, well, padded, but still very hard concrete floor. And now drop kick from Leo, sending Isaac into the LED board. And the fans are not happy with this. Oh my goodness. Oh lordy. Ah! That's horrific. Face first into the padded concrete floor. That is horrible. But that is what Isaac Kinley does. Ah! Oh, just continuing to use our LED board. Like, that's not a weapon. That's expensive. That's an expensive bit of equipment. Oh, Golden Phoenix. He's going up to the top. Oh, nice shooting star press from the Golden Phoenix. But he's not done with Leo, and Leo's not done with him. Oh, close eye. Meanwhile, good lord, stop using our LED board, you psychopaths. Jesus Christ. I know the budgeting on IW is higher than GHK, but doesn't mean we're made of money. Oh, Pepsi Man takes out Isaac. Meanwhile, Leo about to take out the Golden Phoenix. Leo, gonna try and put him out once and for all. Leo thought he would never. Leo thought he'd taken out Golden Phoenix for good. Considered himself weighed down by the Golden Phoenix, but the Golden Phoenix wants to take out Leo. Before we get a regular match between those two, when we have the time for it. Oh, boom! Leo tries to low-key menace, tries to do what Hope Halliwell did just not too long ago against Sophia Muller. Oh, Leo though, now gonna deal with Samuel. Oh, good lord, we've seen this before. Oh, good god, and keep, and that is gonna do it, surely. Wait, no, Isaac. Isaac's still in this. Now Isaac and Leo squaring off here. Oh, this is gonna get nasty. This is gonna get brutal. Look at this. Oh, here we go. What is Leo planning here? Oh, draping Isaac into the tree of woe. Oh no, Isaac's trying to get himself out of this. But I think he's getting himself into position. Oh, double foot stomp. Meanwhile, Golden Phoenix wants to try again against Leo. But Leo is full of energy, full of momentum. And he's going to try and take out the Golden Phoenix once again. Oh god, Menace is now in. And I don't think Leo's going to keep that going. Oh, Menace with a vicious backdrop. Goes for a pinfall here. And Samuel's getting back in. Breaks the pin up. Now Menace going after Samuel. Golden Phoenix going after Isaac. Good work there by Golden Phoenix. Good work there by Menace. Oh, good lord, Menace. Going for several attitude adjustments here. Oh, that's horrible. Meanwhile, Isaac Kinley biting the face of the Golden Phoenix. Isaac Kinley is a sadistic individual. Oh, what's Leo doing here? What's Leo doing here? Oh, good God. Driving Menace face first into the side of the ring, one of the hardest parts of the ring. Meanwhile, Golden Phoenix pinfall. Two. And a kick out from Isaac Kinley. Oh, Leo going after Golden Phoenix. Golden Phoenix trying to focus on Isaac Kinley, but no luck there. And now an Irish whip sends Leo tumbling to the outside. Oh, Samuel going to focus on Isaac Kinley then. Going to go for a Dragon Sleeper here. Menace is coming in though. And Menace takes out the referee and Isaac Kinley making the escape here. Oh, good Lord. Look at this. Look at Menace with the backdrop. Oh, good Lord. Oh, Samuel makes the dodge. And Samuel driving the foot into Menace, knocking him silly. Hurricane Rana from Leo takes down Isaac. Samuel with the Irish Whip into the corner, but he's not going to be able to capitalize on it because Leo's gone for Samuel now. Oh, that is horrible. Stomping on the arm there, but Samuel not letting it stop him. Nice Hurricane Rana there from Samuel the Savior. And now Samuel finally going to capitalize on Menace, but Menace has had a chance to recover. But Samuel going to still keep trying regardless. Oh, boom! That's going to hurt the face. Now, Samuel going over to the top rope. Look at this. Oh, he's waiting for Leo, but I think Golden Phoenix. Not going to let that happen. Oh, good God. Oh, my God. Samuel was not going to be denied. He took Leo down. And I won't be denied. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my word. This match has been going a million miles an hour. Leo takes down Isaac Kinley. Leo tries to take down the Golden Phoenix, but Golden Phoenix comes in. Beautiful work there by the Golden Phoenix. And now Golden Phoenix is the only one standing still. Golden Phoenix rushing over. I think he's going to try and put this one away. Oh, look at this. And he's flying high. Oh, but Isaac's up. Isaac breaks the pin up. That could have been a perfect moment for the Golden Phoenix. Oh, Isaac tried choking out Leo, but Golden Phoenix going to stop Isaac Kinley here. Meanwhile, look at that. 4-5-4 splash from Pepsi Man, Samuel Savior. Oh, look at Menace now. Driving Golden Phoenix into the ground. Meanwhile, nice Texas Cloverleaf from Samuel the Savior. Isaac Kinley breaks it up, however. Oh, lordy. Samuel going over to the top rope once again. And 630 senton! 630 senton! Menace breaks it up, however. And now Menace gonna take care of Samuel the Savior. Golden Phoenix now, considering what he needs to do, he's going after Leo again. His rival Leo. Big suplex from the Golden Phoenix. And now Menace gonna take out Isaac Kinley. Oh, with a brain buster. And now a nice leg lock from the Golden Phoenix. Didn't break it up with that one. The Golden Phoenix had that one in tight. But a combined work there from Menace and Leo managed to break it up. Oh, Menace is going to put away Isaac Kinley here. He wants to try and put away Isaac Kinley. Look at this. Meanwhile, submission of Boston Crab. Isaac reverses the finisher. Samuel and Leo. Leo and Golden Phoenix really want to hurt each other. The fact that they are so tightly holding onto those submission holds. Oh, good God! Samuel jumps to the outside with that elbow drop to take out Leo. Hurricane Rana. My word. I was saying about how, like, Golden Phoenix and Leo really want to hurt each other because they took a lot to break up those submissions. Leo's been busted open. Now Samuel rushing over to break up the submission hold. Oh, that kick there manages to help Golden Phoenix escape. And now Samuel sending Golden Phoenix Irish Whip into the corner. Oh, nice. Tiger Suplex going for a pinfall here. One, two. Oh, broken up there by Isaac Kinley, who realised just what was happening right there. And now Menace looking to put away Samuel the Saviour. Boom! Another brain buster. And Samuel rolls to the outside. Oh my God! I was talking about being low keyed earlier. My word, it doesn't get much stiffer than that from Isaac Kinley on the outside. Leo not going to let that stop him. I don't think we're seeing another low key finish like what we saw earlier with Hope Halliwell on Sophia Muller. Meanwhile, Golden Phoenix taking down Menace on the outside. And Golden Eagle. Golden Phoenix, my apologies. Standing moonsault from the Golden Phoenix. Golden Phoenix now dragging Menace into the center of the ring. Nice work right there. Oh, Leo going for Isaac though. And looks like Leo, oh, and a stiff kick. Golden Phoenix gets out of the way, but Leo going after the Golden Phoenix, who was distracted. Tiger suplex. And now Menace, oh, with a drop kick, but dodged out of the way. But Leo's not dodging out of these blows. Oh, German suplex from Menace. And now Menace, I think, going to try and put this one away. Irish whip into the corner. Oh, Leo, though, boots Menace in the face. And now look at this. Oh, Menace reverses it. Oh, look at this now. Samuel gets Menace just right at the right point in time. And now working the legs over. Meanwhile, look at that. Good work there by Leo. Takes down Isaac Kinley, who was trying to get back into the action. Oh, nice inzaghi there from Samuel the Savior. Oh, Samuel catches Leo. Nice Hurricane Rana. Takes him down. And now a Dragon Sleeper from Samuel the Savior. Could be trying to put away Leo here. Could he do it? He's tapped. Leo has tapped out. And that means Samuel the Savior, Pepsi Man, wins. Oh my goodness. Oh, that was a roller coaster of emotion right there, this match. Like I said, this is a great showcase for you. If you don't watch all of the Mountaintop, if you don't watch Mountaintop, if you don't watch Genesis, you don't watch Virtual Shock, and also, you get, you know, then we hope that this has shown you what these shows are capable of. And also, you've gotten to have a little taste of some of the GHK superstars. So maybe this will incentivize you to check out GHK when it comes back from its hiatus. But Genesis's very own Samuel the Savior with a huge victory here in this five-man match. A great victory, a great upset. We've seen some unexpected victories here. We've seen a low-key victory and now a Dragon Sleeper tap out. And now we're going to move on to the main event. In the main event, like I mentioned earlier, it's between the Phantom, backed by Blood and Gore, who will be taking on the Reaper, backed by Black Death and Scarecrow. Oh, this is good. What a way to end things off here. By two people who don't need to be in costume, though, the Reaper has changed things up for Halloween. Here comes the Phantom. Now, if you haven't seen the Phantom, yet another member who is going in to the World League tournament. But the Phantom and Blood and Gore have laid a path of destruction in their way. Blood and Gore have been tearing it up in the tag scene. They won't be going for the tag team titles this time around, but they have been devastating a lot of tag teams that they face. And then you have the Phantom, who has won gotten his ticket to the World League tournament. But on top of that, every single time the Phantom wins a match, he sends Blood and Gore in to do the finishing blow, the exclamation point. He did it first when he beat Diamond Dimitri. He sent Blood and Gore to take out Japanese wrestling legend Tsunami Frank. And then after that, he went on and he fought BVC. He beat BVC and qualified for the World League tournament. And then he sent Blood and Gore to beat the disco legend BVC. Not disco legend, but I couldn't think of any other words at the time. My throat is killing me. Oh my goodness. The disco dancer BVC was just decimated. And I think if Phantom gets his way here, he will do exactly the same to the Reaper. But he's got a hell of a task on his hands, because the Reaper, while maybe didn't qualify for the World League tournament, is one of the most dangerous individuals you will ever meet. One of the most powerful individuals in intense wrestling. A two-time world champion. Someone who has beaten many people. Someone who very few have ever beaten. And for Halloween, he's is gone, his mask red. He's coming out as Satan. Because to many people who go mental, some people drive themselves mad trying to beat the Reaper. So to them, the Reaper might as well be Satan. The Reaper, not good, not evil. The Reaper is the Reaper. And he has devastated many individuals on his time at the top. Despite not being in the running for the world title, I'd hardly say his reign of darkness is even close to over. His era of darkness, I'd say, is only just beginning. You see Scarecrow and Black Death, like I mentioned earlier, aligning themselves with the Reaper. Now, I should point out the Reaper not relying on them often, but is using them at the moment because of the immense numbers of the Storm System. Keep in mind that Aaron has Thomas Swole, Alan Bannon, Bruce Stubbs, Keith Storm, and I'm sure I'm missing some. The point is that the Storm System have a lot more people. And so Scarecrow and Black Death are giving their services to help the Reaper out against these insurmountable odds. And likely in this case, helping to stop Blood and Gore from getting involved, because Blood and Gore have proven their eagerness in the past to help out the Phantom, even during a match. Meanwhile, Phantom showing pride that he doesn't need that he can win the matches on his own. And he only sicks Blood and Gore after the match is over. Not saying that I condone that, by the way, but I'm just stating the facts here. Now, back and forth here at the moment. The Phantom getting the better of it, but the Reaper not staying down. The Reaper just, look at this, back and forth right now. Good Lord. Oh, and now choking out the Phantom here. Oh, that is brutal. Look at this, the Phantom taken down by the Reaper here. The Reaper bringing the Phantom back up to his feet. And a big DDT. Wait a minute, Blood, this is what I was talking about. Blood and Gore trying to help out the Phantom here. Blood distracting the Reaper, allowing the Phantom to come back in. And now the Phantom with a rib breaker, able to turn things back into his favor. Oh, wait a minute. Blood, I think Blood's not done yet. Oh, the Phantom dealing with the Reaper. And Blood has brought a chair into proceedings. But the thing about the Phantom is he will not use that chair. This isn't the first time we've seen this. Blood now trying to deal with the turnbuckle. You see Blood over-eager to help out the Phantom. But the Phantom is not going to take advantage of that chair. Because the thing with the Phantom is that he's always willing to prove that while he has Blood and Gore at his side, he doesn't need to cheat to win, to prove why he's the leader of that threesome. Oh, here we go now. The Phantom diving down. Oh, didn't get all of it, but definitely took down the Reaper. A stiff kick from the Phantom. This match is frenetic between two of the top individuals of Intense Wrestling right now. The Phantom not able to put it away just yet, though. The Reaper getting back up to his feet here, and the Reaper takes the Phantom down. Oh, look at this. Grabs the Phantom and brings the Phantom back down. Oh, the Phantom caught, catches the Reaper and takes the Reaper down with a leg screw, but the Reaper is getting right back up. So the Phantom takes the Reaper back down with a clubbing blow right there. The Phantom's going to have to hit something big here if he wants to put the Reaper away. Because if he doesn't, the Reaper is going to keep coming back. Oh, Phantom, nice, barely dodges that big fine clothesline. Oh, but the Reaper takes down the Phantom here. One, wait a minute. Are you joking? You're seeing the loyalty of Blood and Gore, who will do anything to ensure that the Phantom doesn't win. But our referee has said enough is enough. You're getting out of here, Blood, if you are going to keep getting involved. And now it's just Gore. Blood has been sent backstage. And now the Phantom taking a fair bit of offense here from the Reaper. Oh, now Gore's turn to try and distract the Reaper. Give the Phantom some time to recover. Oh, but I think the Phantom might not be able to just yet. Oh, the Phantom has had time to recover. And oh, Gore bought Phantom enough time. He bought his leader enough time. But the Reaper gonna fix that right away. And the Reaper now, we're gonna choke out. He's gonna choke out the Phantom. We've seen this take out a fair share of opponents. He could choke out the Phantom right here. The Phantom, if he falls unconscious, and he has, he's unconscious. The referee has called for the bell. The Reaper has won. What a victory here in this matchup. Happy Halloween, ladies and gentlemen. And what a scary victory for the Reaper. Like, Reaper, really? Like, my God, Phantom was close. I've got to say that. I think the Phantom was very close to winning. But the Reaper showing why he is one of the most dominant individuals in intense wrestling. Why he's one of the most successful individuals in intense wrestling. And why so few people can lay claim to beating him. The Phantom, as good as the Phantom is, wasn't able to do it this time. Maybe next time, but I guarantee you, this won't be the last time we'll be seeing these two squaring off. Anyway, happy Halloween, ladies and gentlemen. If you enjoyed this, please remember to check out the free paper, free rosters. Make sure to check out Intense Wrestling's Mountaintop. Make sure to check out Intense Wrestling's Genesis. And be sure to check out Intense Wrestling's Virtual Shock, the latest show on the Intense Wrestling show roster, you know, set of rosters. And also, when it comes back from hiatus, check out GHK. If you enjoyed, please remember to leave a like on this video, subscribe for more, and hit that notification bell, and share this video with your friends. And we'll see you next time.